promising untold opportunities beckon. Silently, they orbit the sun, waiting.
A quick smack around the face always works.
Oh.
Big quick smack around the face. What's going on? What have I missed? What have I missed?
I've got on my face when that's just like,
yeah.
Okay, so is everyone able to hear everybody? I just want to make sure audio is
hopefully they can good. Hear me after what I just said. Completely joking if anyone did actually hear what I said.
What's that? Let me know how. Check hashtag audio so I can turn people up if they're too soft and vice versa. I think I'll turn everyone up a bit. Audio check, please. You can't hear Mac. All right, let's turn everyone up a bit then.
He's bullshitting you. He's got to be bullshitting.
Yeah. Can't hear Mac, so we're up to 100. We'll bring everyone up. Let's bring everyone up. How are we doing? Oh, wrong channel. There we go. Wrong channel. Don't accidentally hit the AFK button. It's the one thing that's a pain in the ass is audio. How's audio now, guys? Can everyone hear everyone okay? Talk for me. Talk to me. Okay, so we'll just imagine that everybody's good and we'll just keep rolling onwards. And if anyone wants to tell me if anyone's too quiet or whatever, I will try and adjust to the best of my ability. But welcome, guys. Episode 52, Addicted Podcast, 1 year. 1 year I've been doing this freaking podcast. Unbelievable. It feels like it. Wow, I cannot believe it was... Right, if I was to bring up a video... Hang on, let me just... I think there is a video of the very first ever podcast. Hang on.
If Twitch works.
Let's just find
one. They deleted my fucking VODs, bastards. So.
This episode one. Episode one. So this was the original. Hang on, let's just.
He does
bring
look
it up.
Like Princess Leila.
Fuck you all. Fuck you.
Oh, he does. He does. You're right. This was the original. This was the original podcast.
I stopped using it because it's like they were so big.
All right, whatever.
There it was, January the 3rd, the Addicted Podcast. Nice. That was it. So that was the original cast. So we had Pathogen, we had Biomechanical, we had Kurosaji, this was the original team, and you had myself. On this episode, if anyone ever curious, I actually had masking tape on my headphones to keep my headphones from staying on my head.
We need to start a crew of headphone fuckers.
Just an observation, though, of those four assholes, there's only one left, is there?
It's of the four assholes. Well, Pathogen, I think, is just having a break. Bio's obviously doing what Bio's doing. Kira's doing what Kira's doing, and I'm still doing it at the moment. The Addicted Podcast. So yes, but this was the original. This was the original four people. This was the original layout and everything. And then you've all seen what the current logo and everything else. So it was just it was interesting. That was the original crew. Now, look at much.
The original cast moment. What day was that?
That was the anniversary. We've passed the official anniversary's passed. It was, I think we did it. We did that was the third of that was the initial that was uploaded on the third, but I think we did it like literally a couple weeks earlier to that or something, like before Christmas, and then it was uploaded. So we're officially way past it, but yeah, there you go. The audio has everyone except Little Bit of Madness has low audio. Yeah, I'm struggling to understand why everyone's audio is so quiet.
On your source, go to the Discord one and turn it up.
On my source, yeah, I've done that.
Well, what is it on source?
Yeah, everyone's really loud. So everyone's physically everyone, or do I need to?
Then you would have to do us all through Discord.
No sound.
Or voice meter, sorry. You can do it through the voice meter, I think. No, voice meter is just for you.
Listen, man's not hot. He doesn't understand that.
I know. I feel like I should run a freaking audio course for you lot.
Alright, okay, so...
an audio course. Fucking hell, need a whole streaming course.
Yeah, that's it, true. Mac does
need you to get a green screen.
Alright, try this, don't worry.
You've I'm got cranking. One, I know, but it's not set up.
I'm cranking everyone up.
We've been here before, haven't we?
Yes.
You know I'm my cranking... way out of this one.
I don't understand why everyone would be turned down so low, but I'm guessing it's... I don't know. It's normally fine, but since I've been doing it through the virtual audio cable, everyone's suddenly gone really quiet, so... Oh, God, fuck it. Honestly, Streamlabs...
Discord, then, is that, that's about the extent of my
knowledge. Yeah, I've turned everyone up on Discord to nearly 200%. I've increased the voice audio output cable, output volume. Yeah, output is now up at 200%, so it's like fucking at the max. It's at the max. I just don't understand...
What? Everyone at home, turn your headphones up. There you go.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure. I mean, I can't turn it up anymore.
Our remote's still dead as well. What are Twitch doing?
Mine are working.
What?
Everyone's loud.
Oh, man.
Emotes are dead? Lame.
Not for everyone.
Lame.
For me.
Anyway.
Right, so the other thing you can do is add a game on the Discord.
Again. Oh, what the audio? Or actually on Discord?
No, on your XSplit.
Amazing grace. How sweet the sound.
What's the next last... line? Nobody knows.
Yes. I'm not quite sure how to enable a gain on that.
What is the issue? Is everyone just too quiet?
Users. We're all really quiet.
Like are you guys
OBS
crazy?
And sorry, OBS and what do you call them? Streamlabs. Yeah. Something. Do you know what?
I've installed it.
You're good.
You seem okay on mine. I just put you on my iPad and you seem okay.
They're trolling you then. Are we good? Are we passable, guys, for audio?
Yeah. Fuck you. You're fine. You're fine.
Well,
fuck you. You're fine.
Quiet. We're all quiet, but fuck it.
You seem alright on mine.
We said that earlier. What was it? Red something, right?
Yeah. Who needs to hear us, anyway?
I'll turn myself... I mean, I can turn myself down a little
red
bit.
Red on.
Someone's saying you have to press F5. Maybe it's Twitch then.
Press Alt F4. That always helps.
I'll turn myself. I mean, I can turn myself down.
We can hear you. Hearing you.
Yeah. Hearing me. Hearing me. Yeah. Sorry, because I can hear. I am louder. Way louder than you guys. That's for sure.
Well, can you turn you down, and then we'll all just send temperature. Everyone can turn their audio off.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I'm doing. I'm just turning me down. And then I will bring my balance in. So I bring my down 50%, which should bring everyone in. But honestly, every time, this never stays the same. It's ridiculous. Every fucking time.
Streaming for you, that's just fucking part and parcel, isn't it?
Gotta love it. Might want to normalize it later, but it is intelligible. It's intelligible. I don't know what, like, I don't normally do it through the virtual audio cable. I usually just do it through Discord, and it's always been okay. But today I thought I'd do it through the virtual audio cable, you know, so it would work. Obviously, it's worked worse. Brilliant.
Work worse.
The red pineapple is the problem, man.
Yeah, so just let us know if we're now about the same sort of level. We're about the same.
I mean, if not, I'm just trying to think of what else you can do to change it, but...
I don't think there's anything else I can do. Only thing I could do is literally just go back to just playing the audio directly through Discord and not have it through the virtual audio cable. But then that just means me fiddling around for another 5-10 minutes at the beginning of the show.
Let's fiddle around a bit. Let's do that, you know?
You want me to fiddle around with it? Is it that bad?
Yeah, just do it. I had a weird fucking dream yesterday, man.
That's why I wanted you to fiddle around with it, so he can start telling you about the dream.
But a weird
no one's going to hear it. But
I can't fucking chat anymore. I can't see chat, and I can't chat.
I can.
Is that a good thing? Then we don't hear your keyboard all the damn time.
Whatever. Whatever. Magical keyboard sound.
That was a good Layla impression, though. Whatever.
She never said that, ever.
What did she say, man?
Right.
I can't think of any quotes.
I've changed the audio. I think everyone should now be about a million times louder, right?
Hello!
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 We're going to spend another an hour and a half doing this now.
Sol is very low. That's a good thing.
There we go.
Yeah.
Sound is loud.
Sound is loud now. Oh, that's surprise, good. Surprise.
We'll stick with that.
That's good. Loving me and loving you.
It's better to be too loud because then they can turn us down.
They can turn you down. Mm. Exactly.
Right.
Which is so what women have been doing all my life.
Let's get the balance right. Let's get the balance right. Right, okay. Bloody hell.
Perfect. The thing is, they got a 30-second delay, so they say it's too loud, so you turn it down. Then they say perfect. He's like, oh, shit, no, that was before. Yeah. It was perfect, so you turn it back.
That delay's a killer.
This is it, exactly.
It's like fucking...
What's it like? Tell us. Finish that sentence. Everyone,
we need you guys to tell us whilst I disable all these other...
Oh, good, stick to that. Don't touch anything.
Let's keep it.
Let's go for it.
Hang on. You guys talk. Just talk whilst I disable, because I've got to disable the audio from every single fucking channel.
I mean, we could go around what we've all been doing.
Yes, do that. Let's do that, what we normally do. That really important thing that we introduce everyone, what everyone's been up to. So go for it. Go.
And welcome, everybody, to the Addicted Podcast number 52, where we have technical difficulties. It's a year on, and we still cannot start a podcast without technical difficulties.
No. Don't talk about that.
We are joined today by the wonderful guests, Mr. Sol.create and Super Mac Brothers Ryan. Welcome, guys.
Cheers.
Why don't you tell us what you've been up to, Sol, if you want to tell us what you've been up to for the last few weeks. Or do you want to finish eating first?
No, I'm good, man. I'm good. I needed to uphold my old tradition of grabbing food just before the podcast starts.
Yes, so. Really loud and crunchy food just before we start. That's what I like.
No, I'm getting his trousers on.
I've toned down a bit. I've grabbed chocolate and stuff.
Toned down a bit.
You know. On a serious note, very busy with work within the beautiful Twitch community, doing my designs, panels, overlays, etc. Books full up until mid-February at the moment, so that's been great.
Yeah, Sol, congrats on that endeavor, because you just started that quite recently and you've done really well, mate. So
it's been hard, good man. It's a lot of work. I make long days. For example, because I have a lot of American customers and I'm constantly dealing with them, for this upcoming month, I'll probably be living on an American time schedule, so I'll be sleeping during the day and I'll be up during the night.
Yeah, those Yanks could be a pain in the ass.
Oh my God, yeah. Been doing some streaming as well. On a daily basis, we're back again, 8 o'clock every day. Been doing some Hellion with drones, been playing some Star Citizen. Hopefully some Tarkov soon as well, which I wanted to do. But mainly, we'll keep it with creative streams. Tuesday to Saturday, through to Saturday, Sunday and Monday are my days off. And I've seen a lot of people return, which is great. Very happy with that. And we'll keep on grafting, man. Keep on doing that work.
And what is the work?
I've done the panels for Crucian. They're done. I couldn't talk about that because that was all introduced in 2018. I can tell you now. Overlays, stop start streams, all every graphics a content creator on Twitch would, could, or want to need is what SolidCreate creates.
Awesome.
So if you need anything, hit me up, solidcreate.com, or grab me on Discord. discord.gg/solidcreate.
Cool. Good stuff.
Mm. Mr. Super Mac Brothers.
Feel free to link it, dude.
You do like a hairdresser's weekend, don't you? Sunday, Monday. It's a hairdresser's weekend.
Yeah.
Well, I still work then, but I try not to stream and have a bit of, just...
A bit of soul time.
I was working too much. I was doing 12-hour days every damn day, and I had to say to myself, okay, now you need to just cool down a bit,
Do a bit of yoga.
I don't drive a Ford Escort, though, so I'm good. Cabriolet.
What's wrong with the Ford
Escort? I drove MG.
It's a car dresser's car. It's a car dresser's
car. Okay, hold on. Whoa. What is a car dresser? I don't want to know what a car dresser is. That sounds fantastic. I want that job. I want to be a hairdresser. Get up in the morning.
It's basically a word for someone that cleans cars.
What color wheels are we wearing? What color wheels are we having?
What rims am I putting on?
Rims am I putting on this one?
We all like a bit of rims.
bit of rusty trombone.
Moving nicely on from that one. Mike, you want to tell us what you've been up to?
Saul, did you get your link in yet?
Oh, no. Oh, that was what I was doing.
Link yourself in. Get yourself in there. Don't worry.
Do it.
Link yourself in, mate.
I've been ill, to be honest. I've just been ill, doing nothing. I was really getting into streaming. I was really excited for 2018. Making this the year of Star Citizen, definitely. And I was all hyped to go, and then I got struck down in the prime of life by Australian bird flu, or whatever the fuck it's called. I don't know what it is.
But I mean, everyone's had it.
Yeah. But it was only for 3 days. I was sort of, snotty. I couldn't really talk. I didn't want to. One of my latest videos, you can hear how snotty I was. So, and that was on a good day. So, but today I'm back streaming, which is good. I did a stream earlier today, which was a lot of fun. Thank you, everyone who joined me. I'm not going to be streaming tomorrow, but I'm planning to stream the rest of the week. Checking out a new band on Thursday, getting my hair cut tomorrow.
Busy week.
Yeah, it's going to be good. I'm enjoying it. So, yeah, that's pretty much all I've done so far. Oh, lots of giveaways, though. We've got a Banu Merchman giveaway happening right now. We've also got a fuckload of giveaways in February.
I watched your YouTube and you reeled them off, and I was like, holy shit. That is a lot of giveaways.
Someone
broke into CIG and just...
They have.
It's amazing.
They've stolen all the ships. And we're trying to do a subfest at the moment,
Subfest,
basically. Yeah.
These are not cheap ships, though, to be given away. That's the thing. It's not like chump ships. It's like reclaimers, freelancers.
None of those Merlin ships.
Yeah, none of this starter pack rubbish, $35.
I love how you're on page one of that, Mac.
I've used it well, I've really put it to good use.
It's like when you do your birthday streams, you're pissed out of your head, giving ships away left, right, and centre. It's all right, I'm going to make notes.
I found that piece of paper somewhere. From that first birthday stream, I found that piece of paper recently as I was clearing everything out, and I was like, fuck, how did I even... follow any of... Literally, 3 a.m, and we're like, you've won that.
I know. That's it. By the time 3 o'clock, it's like, you were just giving shit away.
Oh, just done. You're like, don't give away your... But anyway, that's pretty much what I've done. Let's move it along. Move along.
Move along.
And ready that madness, you can...
Loving you.
I've been crazy busy. I mean, I've been super sick over Christmas and New Year. I had whatever... Similar thing to you, I had a sinus infection... I had all sorts of horrible things going on. I think it was generally a withdrawal symptoms to stopping alcohol, because I don't know if anyone knows, but I have probably borderline heading towards becoming an alcoholic over the last couple of months. So
that's why we're honouring him by drinking water.
Yeah.
So I've cut it out. So you may see me wearing drinking what appears to be a wine glass. It is not, in fact, wine.
It's the tricky mind.
It is Schlur. It is white. It's white grape. It's classy.
Apparently, his own white grape is quite good as well.
Used to look at Schlur. White grape's good. What tosser is going to drink?
Fuck you.
Let's have some Schlur tonight, darling.
I have to drink some. It's one of those. It's become a force of habit. It's a bit like a smoker. Do you know what I mean? Like I've generally got an addictive personality, and I'm an ex-smoker myself. And so for me, I have to generally, a bit like kind of Chris Roberts does something with his hands. It's like I kind of feel like doing the podcast and doing streaming drinking kind of seems to go together. So I have to try and supplement it. So no more booze, but I have to try and get something else.
I have to say that it's a real downfall of streamers when you don't because you don't realize you're there for a few hours on end and you just get so used to it. I went through a habit of drinking every time I streamed, and I thought, fuck me, I'm drinking like 6 bottles a day, 5 days a week. It really adds up, and you don't realize how much it creeps on you. And then so you've done well, honestly, Madness, to just cut it out completely.
I just kind of I woke up and I had a like, it just was not well, and I just was like, you know, sometimes not being well, and your body's kind of saying to you, like, you're doing too much, you're pushing too hard, it's time to just take it easy and stop some, make some life changes. And so I did it before Christmas. I didn't do it one of these, like, New Year resolution things. I just was like, nope, I'm going to change some shit up and get healthy, and it's making a big difference, I have to say. I mean, I miss it, I'm not going to lie. I like getting shit-faced. It's just part of what I've been doing for years. But I recognised that it was causing causing some damage, and it was time to call it a day. So,
no, we did an intervention with a little bit of madness.
Yeah, I had a few people say, "Calm down,
madness, start drinking Schlur, mate, because you're down in these."
So now the Addicted Podcast is starting again. He'll probably start drinking.
I'll be back on it again. Exactly, the stress of this lot.
To be honest, the more you stop drinking, the less like you think about it. You just have something else.
Yeah.
I do drink now and again, but hardly anything compared to what I used to, because it just became a habit, which I think is what happens. Break that habit, it's not so bad.
You know, when it becomes, I had it over the last few weeks, when I found out about 62% rum and pineapple juice, that's when it went a bit wrong with me. So I had to say to myself, Bram, you don't drink this like Coca-Cola or like 7-Up or something. Maybe you just need to drink it in the evening. But the evening for me is like 2 in the morning. You know what I mean? So it's like really weird. I basically went to bed drunk at like 7, 8 o'clock in the morning. Everyone's waking up here in the UK.
I tell you what, I haven't done much though. I didn't play any Star Citizen over Christmas. Mainly because I was away, but I didn't play any Star Citizen. I didn't have a real inclination to want to play it too much,
if I'm being honest.
You know what it is? I didn't.
I was like, the combat wasn't there, so for me, I was away for most of it, and I did come back for a week. But when I came back for the week, I was like, I just didn't really want to kind of do it. I was like, I want to kind of chill, and I want to then... I had plans. I've got a lot of plans for this year in terms of the stream and everything else that I wanted to kind of put in place and kind of write down. And you'll hear a bit more about that kind of stuff later. But, you know, I just wanted to do that, you know, so I didn't really play Star Citizen. But I kept my, you know, I was reading up on the news and, you know, checking what's going down in terms of Star Citizen. Obviously, not a lot was going down because everyone's on holiday. So I was like, well, they're on holiday. It's a good time for me to be on holiday as well. So.
You know what it is with Star Citizen at the moment? I don't know how it is for you guys. I think everyone's having the issue. I'm not getting more than 20 frames, you know, and it's playable above 16, I think, you know. But I think to get the optimal experience, we want at least the 30, you know.
Great today. Me and Miz, we played, it was much better than the PTU. The PTU was a lot worse.
It was a lot better than the PTU, don't get me wrong. But I think maybe we need to wait a little bit more till we get that little bit more performance, and then it's going to be perfect. I'm still having fun, you know. I'm still having great fun. I missed the 10 frames.
It won't feel like the same game when we get 30, 60 FPS.
Oh, man, it's going to be madness. Like,
what is this? It's going to be madness.
It will be madness. No, it
on Schlur.
On Schlur, madness on Schlur. It will be.
Like madness on Schlur.
On Schlur. At the moment, it's going to be.
Don't even know what I mean.
I'm going to have to get an emote. We have to get the Schlur remote going across the screen or something.
Oh, that's a great drink. It's actually really nice stuff. I take the piss, but I really like it.
It is all right.
It's always at Christmas time. I think it was because I was at my parents.
The flour in it. That's a bit weird.
It's advertised as the adult cordial or adult soft drink or something, isn't it?
So, guys, I'm a non-UK citizen. Well, I'm living in the UK, but I'm a non-UK. What is Schlur?
Okay, so it's all right. So Schlur is it's right. Light on its feet. It's full of delicately crisp white grape juice. Has the occasional all sewn up.
It's like a non-alcoholic wine, but it doesn't.
It's a non-alcoholic.
Listen, if you leave that in the basement for a couple of weeks,
no,
it's alcoholic. I tell you.
It's nice.
There's cauliflower in it.
It's nice. This is not. But if anyone's tuned in, this isn't the non-alcoholic.
That's why it's called addicted. We're talking about everything given up in January.
This is all about. This is the rehab. This is actually the rehab show now, and we're all kind of like in rehab. This is no longer the addicted.
Are you in an asylum by any chance?
Probably, yeah, I think so.
Welcome, my name is Madness. I used to be an alcoholic, now I drink Schlur. My life is Back on track.
Back on track.
It should be the Alcoholics Anonymous drink. That's what they should advertise as. It would sell fucking loads.
Just to really trigger people that are alcoholics to have loads of bottles that look like wine.
My name is a little bit of madness. I like spaceships,
yeah, there you go.
And alcohol, you know.
It's a teenage girl's wine. It's not wine. It's not even wine. There's nothing in it. It's to drink something.
The hairdresser's drink.
Yeah, because I tried the I've tried the non-alcohol. I mean, I know we're talking about. I'm sorry for anyone that's coming to talk about Star Citizen, but there's nothing to talk about. I drank the non-alcoholic beers and stuff. I've tried them. I've tried a few of those different types of ones of those, they're horrible. I was like,
they are horrible.
I was like, I can't drink that. I can't drink that.
I went to see a mate of mine, and he always drinks this non-alcoholic stuff. I was like, what the fuck is this? Can't you just drink a fucking Coca-Cola?
Yeah, that's that. I'm like Coke, and then maybe like some Schlur, and some then water. That's it. That's me done.
You know, sorted. If it was called something else, it would be fine. It's just because it's called Schlur. You sound like a twat when you say it.
Sounds like you're trying to be drunk when you talk. What are you drinking? Schlur.
I'm drinking. Yeah, it's like, do you want a cup of tea? Do you want a coffee? Do you want some water? Do you want some Schlur? Do you want some Robinsons? You sound like a dick. There's no way around it.
What, are you slurring your words? No.
It's a Christmas tradition in my house that every Christmas, the out comes the Schlur and the white and the great. It's a Christmas tradition, baby.
I went on a Tinder date the other day. I pulled out my Schlur as well.
My dad doesn't. My dad doesn't even touch this stuff. My dad doesn't touch this stuff.
He's like,
because he's like three quarters of a bottle into a bottle of wine. Like, I ain't having that shit. Yeah. I hate touching that crap. That's for the girls. the alcoholics like you. And he's like, sat there slurring his words. I'm like, oh, would you like some Schlur, Dad, for your
slurring his words.
Slurring his words. Right. Okay.
Awesome.
So
just ask.
Back to Star Citizen, which would be quite quite fun. What's the latest? Oh, the latest on the news will be the Crytek. We'll do the website later. We may as well cover the lawsuit, as it were.
The law.
Let's cover the law.
The
latest information on the lawsuit, I believe, is that CIG is just like Crytek's got no leg to stand on, from what I could read.
Yeah, they gave him the gaming license agreement and was like, well, everything you've just said is no.
So. I haven't really read anything about it because it's all law stuff and everything, but the little bit I did see, I think someone said basically the key line in it is that in the agreement it says neither company can sue each other.
So, yeah, it was.
I've got the link.
Yeah,
that's the case. What the fuck's going on? Basically, you can't sue each other over any. So even what it means, if you break your contract, you can't sue each other, and they both signed and agreed to that. So end of.
If you've not seen that video, this is Leo French or Leonard French. Basically is a lawyer and a tinkler or whatever. Tinker. He basically broke it down in an hour. I mean, Board Gamer broke it down in 20 minutes. I broke it, you know.
And then we took it down in
two seconds.
Just broke it.
Just broke it into 2 seconds. It literally is like exactly what these guys said. I mean, I don't understand how Crytek could think that they would sue them, but then withhold the gaming license, like the original one, and then not expect CIG to go, hang on a minute, you know that original one that we've got, the same as you? Yeah, we're just going to show these guys because it's clear that you're talking bullshit. I mean,
I think it was a last-ditch attempt to try and salvage something to keep their company alive. It was one of those sort of things where they're in the meeting room and they think, shall we try it? There's a potential.
It made it worse, though.
No, not really, because they're fucked anyway. Basically, what it boils down to is they're going to probably end up going bankrupt because they've got no money anyway. And I know in the NHS and stuff as well, like, if you've got a complaint, there will be a point where they won't bother investigating. They'll just settle out of court because it just clears everything away and you can brush it under the carpet. So they were probably hoping that they make it look like a nice, strong claim. Someone will go, do you know what? This ain't worth the hassle. We'll just dust it under the carpet, give them a little settlement out of court. They grab a little bit of cash and then boom, off they go.
CIG wasn't having that, obviously.
They're like, no, it was like a mic drop. Of money. It was like, you've got a lawyer.
Here's the GLA.
Yeah.
But the thing is, it's the only downside is that it sparks the trolls. Not that we should really concern ourselves with the trolls, because
it doesn't make much difference, does it? Because they're just going to spark off of anything. Yeah. That's just one thing.
It just gives them something else to go for. But as we all knew, it was one of these things that was just like most big companies get sued for a lot of things. And often the other company, the smaller companies win or whatever, you know, they have to pay a little settlement. If that was the case, it wouldn't have stumped development or anything like that. It's a separate thing anyway, because the accounts and so forth will be much bigger than what we see. But it is what it is, and it's now pretty much dissolved, which is good news for Star Citizen. Definitely. Not that I was concerned. I wasn't concerned in any way. And I expect over the course of a few years, we'll see some more people trying to...
Yeah, I was just about to say that. I think when you also get a company that's big and doing well, I think you get that anyway. People will think, oh, I'm going to sue you for... And they'll just try on.
Someone making money, someone will try it on, especially in places like California. So,
I mean, I'm suing Mac next week.
So. Yeah, I've got my lawyers on the case, and
I know Harry owns OBS, so I know he's not going to be able to like counter sue it. It'll be fine.
honestly, you can have everything I own. It's not like I've gained it, I've lost anything. It's like, yeah, whatever.
You'll get that little black beard that he has. You can have that with great pride.
I've got that in the charity shop now.
Rats. That's a shame.
Damn, that's only I sound.
That wasn't like 50 pence worth there, wasn't it? That would have covered something.
I wasn't surprised, though, Mac, by the reply of CIG. You know, it's like, remember when we as a community moaned about things, how they reacted? I expected a similar reaction to the, and they did, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They were like, you know what? Stick it somewhere where the light don't shine, you know? And I think it's good. But it was the wrong time to do it to CIG as well. You know, they're just getting out more in the open into the general gaming world with the magazines and all the general public paying more attention to Star Citizen than they used to do before.
Yeah.
And Crytek came and threw it in there, and CIG was like, that guy, you know what I mean? And I think it's they show really like, you know, they're not idiots. They've thought out what they did before, you know. They've thought out, okay, we're going to switch engine or we're going to do something else. Let's check before we do it. They're not morons, you know.
The thing is, this amount of money in any project pays for good lawyers, pays for good staff. So, and it's so important. And the thing is, Chris Roberts knows this. He's a producer. He's, you know, he's living in California.
Dealt with this stuff in terms of conditions for loads of games.
He knows. Everyone in California knows about this sort of thing. So it's just a case of covering your own back, making sure that everything you write, you have these contracts. It's a pain in the ass society. Trust me. Well, I'd say trust me. I don't know. But
trust me, because I
don't know why I said that. It sounds like a pain in the ass society, and I'm sure it is, but it's just the way modern business works in that area of the world. So they are earning millions now. They need to be able to cover this sort of thing, and they have the lawyers to do so, and that's just what it is. It's just lawsuit done, you know?
Yeah,
I think so. I mean,
but we build it more than anything, you know?
Wait and see.
CIG just like, it's nothing. Well, the whole community is like, holy fuck, we're being sued by Crytek. It's like, okay.
It's not just that, though, is it? I mean, the problem is you've got gaming magazines like PC Gamer and things like that, who, at the end of the day, this is what sells their stories. If you just turn around and sell a thing saying, well, this game's nice, it's bumbling along nicely and blah, blah, no one clicks it and reads it. Who wants to read the story that says, CIG are doing well this week? So, like, they love this sort of stuff. It doesn't matter how inaccurate it is or... It doesn't matter. It's just clickbait. So for them, they as soon as they get a whiff of anything like that, they probably live on Derek Smart's Twitter just so they can get at the scoop on this sort of stuff and then quickly get an article on it.
Who?
So that blows it up. Then it gets around the internet quick. And then by the time that's all happened, then everybody, including the community, is like, what's this all about? So,
yeah.
You attract this sort of stuff as well, being the biggest crowdfunded project the world has ever seen, obviously. You will attract these kind of people that try to take a gram out of it, or how do you say it? I don't know how you say it in English, but try to misuse it, you know what I mean? And try to pick a grain from them. And
do you know, I reckon if we just sent round a case of Schlur, they would be fine with it all.
They would be good, you know.
We heard your sue failed. Here's a case of Schlur.
We apologize, you didn't win.
Shall we, just for a joke, send them a crate of Malbec, you know, with the spaceman on it?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, nice.
Hang on a second, guys. 2 seconds. Sorry. 1 second. I think something's going a bit.
One second's
going a bit weird. What the fuck just happened? Oh my god, it's almost like crazy. Welcome, guys. Welcome, everyone, to the new podcast. What? So, what's happened? What's happened? Yes, I hope you enjoyed the little brief introduction and a little bit of bouncing around. That video, by the way, is absolutely insanely cool. Love that. Love that video. It just makes you want to just like. So what's happened? Okay, so last year, about 6 months ago, I kind of wanted to do this, what I'm doing now. My cousin, sadly, last year passed away. A lot of people know this. She was very young, and it kind of made me realize that I just get on with shit and get stuff done. So I'm handing the Addicted podcast back to the Addicted org. Those guys are going to do whatever. So Bio and the rest of the org are going to do their shit. And me and Miz are starting. They could do their shit. They could do their own shit. And me and Miz are going to be starting a new gaming channel called The Asylum. We're going to be doing the same Star Citizen podcast on Mondays every time. So this is just going to change now to The Asylum podcast, as it were. But we're going to do other games. We're going to play games. We're going to do lots of different stuff on YouTube and Twitch. And we're really going to push the boat out. So we're going to be looking for things like patronage and all sorts of stuff. Hopefully, if I can rope Mac in, Mac might do something as well. So I'm sure we can try and rope Mac in. We'll probably have to get paid. I think I'll be sending a couple bottles of Schlur over to Mac.
We'll lock him up. He's all right.
Get him all tempted. So anyway, so welcome to the brand new 2018 podcast show. This is now called The Asylum. It's no longer going to be called The Addicted Podcast. That will be with somebody else, some other guys. Eventually, when I'm not sure, I think they will come out and let you guys know what they're doing with
what
it.
They're doing
but
with it.
Yeah, you broke now, the addiction.
We've broken the addiction. Now we're in the asylum. So
this is the recovery
the stream
process.
Title as well, just to fulfill my OCD.
Oh yeah, don't worry. The stream title. I'm literally about to change the stream title as well. So the stream title will be changing.
Change the title.
Change it now.
No.
Says the man with his fucking washing machine door and the cupboard door open.
Yeah.
Shut the cupboard doors!
Okay.
There you go. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the little break. It's like, oh my god, it's like broken the rhythm, broken everything. All good to go. So,
good job on that, Magnus. That was a good video.
Thank you. Thank you so
much. Happy now. Everybody...
Good stuff.
I enjoyed that.
So I hope you all enjoyed that, and we'll just We're just doing a new thing. If anyone's got any questions and stuff, feel free to ask me. You know, it's something, like I said, me, like, we've been having, there's been a kind of a bit of a thing with people thinking like addicted and the org, the podcast, are kind of like this thing together. And I think we just kind of, a lot of confusion was starting to happen. And that coupled with a few other things, like I said, the main thing is I just wanted to do my own shit and get my own game going and do my own channel with Miz. And that's what I wanted to do. And then I was like, Miz was like doing his thing with the D&D, Stout and Sturdy, and Miserable Gaming and stuff. And so we just had a good chat about it. And we were like, let's just bring it all together, weren't we? Yep. So that's what the plan. So we're bringing it all together and very exciting stuff.
Included in this again.
No, you're not included at all.
First
you're
they
too
want
busy.
Me out.
They want me in, Sol, and then put me Sol, back out again.
Sol will be in charge of the creative side of the asylum. So, I think the idea is we'll do rooms and different things. There's all sorts of cool stuff to come. So
I just love posted. It because he's creating work for me and paying me for it. That's all.
Yeah, for sure.
That's why I like it.
Definitely.
Nah.
Good stuff. Good stuff. Right, where was he? So the Star Citizen schedule. This came out, and the road plan. So this was kind of trying to broke it down. So March 3.1 is their focus for late March, they said. So we will also be working on a long-term goals for this year, in which we plan to deliver the vast majority of systems and mechanics, so players have a variety of options to lose themselves in the verse. The fact that they were saying that I was kind of thinking, well, does that mean that 3.1 is almost ready then, would you say? The way that it sounded to me is like they've already got quite a lot of stuff already done, or is it they got shit nothing done and they need more time?
I think they had a lot left over from 3.0. That's just it's just something that I thought about a week back. Aaron Roberts probably said to Chris on a lot of things, Chris, not going to happen for 3.0.
You're a shitty
brother. Save that up. You're going in too deep, you know. And I think they might have saved some things up, which they were already working on, and they're going to maybe pushing out 3.1 with the new things that they're trying to include. That is my theory. Obviously, I do not work for CIG. I do not know.
Yeah, Thierry Henry. I agree with you, Sol. I agree with you. I think they've been holding stuff back because they want to focus on 3.0, which, you know, they did say they culled a lot of stuff from 3.0 because they didn't have it ready. So, yeah, it's basically just a lot of optimizing, a lot of balancing, a lot of nothing game breaking. Like I hope we'll see some ships. I don't know. But yeah, it's going to be basically making everything bug free, optimized, or as much as they can, and taking what we already have and making it smoother. That's, yeah, I agree. So
coming back on ships, Ryan, what do you think of the current loaner ship?
Buccaneer, is it?
That we have. No. I mean, like, so if you, for example, have a Terrapin, you get an F7C civilian.
Right.
Do you think that is still a viable matrix, or that they need to change that around? It's something that I've been thinking about for the last week, and I'm not really, I don't want to moan about it, but I think we can have some tweaking with the new ships that we have out. You know what I mean?
I haven't really looked at it, and so far, all the ships I own, I have access to, which kind of makes me think I don't give a fuck about anyone else.
No.
But I know a lot of people own a lot of big ships. Like I know there's a few people that only own big ships, and they have all the ships they have access to, they don't own. But it would be better if it made sense to what ships they have. So if it's like a cargo ship, they'll have a bigger, like a smaller cargo ship in place of. But I don't really know what the actual one for one is on these ships.
You think it would just be replaced with something that can perform the same role? Doesn't, like,
yeah.
In some ways, cost
more similar,
matter. It's not there for that. It's not in game yet. As a customer, you bought it, so just swap it for something that can perform a similar role. Really,
yeah,
definitely. How do you feel about it?
But going back on the actual point, sorry. Which was the
I'll tell you later.
The schedule thing is that I think also with the 3.0 is that's what they said in CitizenCon, was it, in that when they get to a point where they want to release it, like say in March or whatever, they're going to just put in what's done and finished, and what's not is going to be not included and put into the next build.
That's
so I suppose
real
kind of seeing
point.
That
yeah.
flow on from that. But I also think that the announcement where they said they're also working on other things at the same time, I think they've told us before that they, I think that's just a little reminder to people that that's what they're always doing, because that's what people think. Oh, you've only been working on 3.0, and they've said that a long time. No, although the focus here is on 3.0, we do have people in different studios working on different things. And I think that kind of just highlighting that, look, we're not just working on 3.1, we're not just working on 3.2 and whatever.
I think we'll see a lot more, well, hopefully a few more weapons, a couple of more ships, some more clothing, some more, you know, different items for sale, just stuff that they've got people working on in the background all the time, which doesn't get held up by the performance and things like this. Because someone asked, why don't they just stop releasing stuff until they get the performance of 3.0 sorted, which is a valid point. You know, if we can't play 3.0 smoothly, what's the point in releasing anything else? But the thing is, why would they hold off on everything else unless it was ready? The only thing I can think is if it's a ship that they're introducing and it could bring more bugs, then yes, hold off on that one. But yeah.
But it's the same with everything. They got, you can't just hold on everything else and work on 3.0, because that's... No. You have half your team just sitting there twiddling their thumbs by saying, well, until you get that sorted, there's no point me working on this, which is an extremely bad way to run a business. You want to get
more than enough running assets going by in the background, yeah. I guess.
There's also an element that if you've got two, you can only have a certain amount of people working on a certain bug anyway, because you're just both, you'll clash into each other. You know, like they can't physically say, well, let's just chuck everybody at bug fixing. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
Definitely. Madness, can you do me a favor? This smoke is blowing in my face all the damn time, man. What can we do with this?
The smoke? Is it in your face?
On the stream, man.
It's like he's doing Rambo. It's like...
Yeah, it's like...
going through the forest. In one addiction. Things keep changing.
It's the one layout. Don't worry.
It's a diva.
He's such a diva, isn't he? He's honestly, there's always someone. I could bring the smoke behind you. Would that make you feel better?
Yeah, then it goes over
my head. Behind you. Yeah.
Then he looks mystical then, rather than
assassin. Let's put the effects. We'll put it behind everybody. There you go.
So while he's messing around with that, what did you think of like the fact that the first patch is in March and that we don't seem to be getting any content-wise?
There's a lot of people saying... Sorry, go on, Sol.
No, no, you go. You start it. I'll do mine afterwards.
No, I love you more.
Okay. So,
I'm gonna go.
What was I saying? Oh, no, I forgot about it.
You're for fuck's sake.
Just because Eden Stars just pointed out the addition of the ass emote. I don't know what's going on, Eden, with everyone seems to be doing ass emotes these days. I don't know if I started a trend.
Man,
I don't know if I started a trend.
That it took his idea.
I know. Man, I'm a bit so. I was like. I was like,
it's male bunkies in speedos, that is.
Yeah.
I think I was like, what's going on? What's happened? What's everyone going crazy for the ass cheek? The
I
ass
know what I wanted to say now. I got it back, by the way.
It's fine.
What I hope is that they at least come through with March, you know what I mean? And it's not going to be like October or August. I hope that they calculated in that there can be mistakes. And hopefully they said to themselves, we want to be finished in April. But we just put March just to be sure, you know what I mean? I hope that they calculated it in this time.
You see, yeah.
I hope that they fix the 20 FPS, though. I hope that we got a fix in between for FPS and maybe smaller bugs, like I think you said earlier, the missions that are bugged and that sort of things. But I'm afraid, I think, let's be all realistic, that it's not going to happen. I wish.
Hang on. But 3.1 is about enhancing performance and polishing the gameplay systems UI, including ships, system traversal, a large balance pass will be of the economy, improving AI for spaceflight and combat. So there's a great deal of stuff that this is to do within the March period of time. So there will be a big improvement to the game.
I mean, I think that's easier for them to hit because there's not actual content as such with that.
Sorry to interrupt.
Go on, you go for that. Go on.
Come on, just talk, boys. Don't be so nice to each other.
The main, like these patches, they will hit. That's the reason why they do. Like they've said that they don't have to hold off content for the main patch of 3.0 now, because 3.0 was just the foundation. So that was so important that they couldn't really introduce anything else until that's done, because it would be pointless. Now that's done, we're going to see lots of stuff come in. And what will happen is, like they've said, if something isn't ready in time, they will just delay it till the next patch. But it won't hold up that patch. So the 3.1 will be whatever we get 3.1. And a lot of people, I think the question is, Miz said something about not getting what we expected for 3.1, like mining. A lot of people have pointed out that we were supposed to get mining for 3.0. We got the prospector, we didn't get mining, and 3.1 doesn't include mining. So it's the next one, the June patch, which I think is frustrating. It would be nice to get these mechanics in, but I think what they're doing is they've got 3.0 sorted. They're going to do a lot of balancing, a lot of optimizing to get 3.0 what they want it to be as a live release, because they pushed it a little early. It should be 100% stable, fully optimized, but optimized to the point that it's playable. And it wasn't, because they wanted to get it out before Christmas. So what they're doing now is they're focusing on getting it as optimized, as balanced. And the economy, ships, everything like that will need a lot of balancing throughout the course. Like, everything will need balancing. Just FPS weapons, clothing, you know, armor protection. Everything will need balancing. So they're getting that done with 3.1. You are, sorry?
They'll make some small improvements, I imagine, to some of the frames, like as they always do, a little bit of here, a little bit there. But it won't be huge. What you want, Saul, is what Space Hip Training says, the same thing. What I would have said is the frame rate won't really get fixed until a lot of the object containers and stuff in September. And later,
that's what I thought as well. You know, and it's not a super bad thing, but I'm like... Yeah, it's playable. I'm having a lot of fun with people. Don't get me wrong. I'm having a lot of damn fun, even though not everything is working correctly. You can still, and I mentioned this before in the podcast when we were still running, you make your own content anyway. You know, you grab three people and you're going to get shenanigans in space, you know. So there is enough to do to keep us busy. Exactly, you know. But, yeah.
As long as your ship's got a bed in the back.
And some schlur.
And some schlur. Goes crazy. So I'm going to bring up something that I don't know if a lot of people remember or a lot of people picked up on, but I'm bringing this. I'm just moving this forward because we've got to move past the schlur. To this point, which is
Thomas, keep the gun on him. He's definitely a criminal.
Okay.
Yes.
Sorry, Thomas.
You didn't finish your sentence.
He's definitely a criminal. I don't quite know what happened then, but never mind. I suddenly got like an audio blast in my ear. I don't know what that was. I don't know what that was. It must be an old sound thing. I haven't switched off.
It's the prawn you're downloading, man. It's the prawn you're downloading.
Oh yeah. Right. Okay. Hang on. I just realized.
My dark top. I look like I'm doing something from the Queen album or something.
You're one of the Kingsmen. D'Artagnan.
Before we get to it,
no, here it is.
I got it.
sorry. I got it. I got it. Okay, so this was at GamesCon. Aaron Roberts was answering a question from Disco.
Oh, look, it's me down there. My SMB notification. I'm famous.
Oh, look, there you are. Just getting reminded about stuff. So this, I'll play it.
Will there be a way in 3.0 for players?
You might have to listen to the stream. I need to do what you do, Miz. Feed it through.
A test run for it.
Well, you'll be able to buy it. You're using Alpha UE.
In 3.0?
Yeah, that's the idea. Basically, the idea is you can be kind of stuff and things like that. So. That's the whole idea is if you've obviously been good enough to support the game and obviously got the package and stuff like that, then you have the ship to fly. But also the idea is we're going to be earning, as we go in, we're going to be earning money so you can buy items for ships, you can do stuff like that, and also and get the other stuff. Now I have to say for 3.0, we're probably not going to make 3.0 now. It's more like 3.1, but the
3.1, okay? So I don't know if you heard that, but basically that's 3.1. They're saying AUEC will buy ships. That's what Aaron was saying.
Yeah, that's May. True.
So, but that's something to be interesting about. So there's been no mention of it, and that's disappointing. But Aaron said it in 2017, at that they were talking about it, and he mentioned it, and I was a bit like, ooh, because this is the big thing, is like, without the ability still in game to be able to buy spaceships, it's still, you know, buying space suits of armor and buying guns is all very well and good, but we still want to buy spaceships. That's ultimately what the goal of earning and doing these trucking things is. It's about being able to buy ships and stuff. So they need... he says it, 3.1, and I'm like, well, where is it? Where is it? Where's the information on this? They didn't bring it up in the schedule. It's not in the schedule report.
I think it's a good chance we won't see that for 3.1. I think they're currently working on a more in-depth schedule report, aren't they? Which is... that was just like a brief, let's just jump on Spectrum and just sort of, you know, point out that we'd just... well, it was on the official website, but it's just a very brief overview. They're actually going to have... this month a more fully developed roadmap for Star Citizen's development, which should hopefully highlight things like buying ships and things like that. It's just a matter of getting the economy to a point where it's worth it. But if they chuck it in now, I'll be happy.
I think also that when you actually read, and like you said, they're probably doing more detailed ones, so maybe it'll be a bit different, but from reading that schedule report, it's kind of more honest. Is that a better way of looking at it? Like, in terms of, they don't look like they've tried to overpromise anything. It's like, true. So the March patch, really, it's just saying we're going to tighten up on what we've just given you with 3.0. There's no really, oh, we're promising you this and we're promising you that, and then not hitting it. So that's what it all looked like. A lot more, this is what we hope, this is what we're more confident of actually delivering, rather than just for now saying all these
things. I agree. They should downplay stuff. Not downplay it as in, like, don't, like, hold back stuff, but if there's something they're not 100% certain about, or not 100% certain, but not confident about, don't say it, because if it does happen, it's going to be an added bonus rather than a disappointment, which I think is a good way of business in this game.
They've listened to us.
Yeah. Well, sorry, go on, miss.
I was just going to say, I think buying ships is a big game changer in that respect. So it's probably quite difficult to do in terms of balancing the economy as well. But also, don't forget, that's going to change their business model, because at the moment they're selling ships and selling concept ships.
Exactly.
As soon as they introduce, they're not saying they're not going to do it because they don't want to do it, but it is a big thing that they've got to be sure that they're ready for that impact, that being able to buy ships in-game is going to hit them.
It's massive. For their financial income, that's what they rely on now is their ship sales, and that's exactly, they'll still have concept sales, which will be out of the game, because concept ships are not ready. But yeah, when it comes to buying ships in game, people and renting as well, people aren't going to
be only a certain selection.
They've got to do it sometime. They got to do it sometime. They got to do it.
Big decision. It's a big.
I'm not saying they're not doing it because a lot of planning. They don't want to do it because of the money impact. I'm saying they've got to plan it, but they've got to be sure they're ready in terms of the mechanic and also ready for what the implications are with it. It's just a lot more, you know, they've just got a lot more figuring out. Is this going to work? We know we've got to do this eventually. Is now the time? Because they don't have to do it now. They don't have to do ASAP. They could wait till beta and then start giving you that sort of stuff. It's obviously development. They don't have to do that sort of thing.
The fact that they, my point is the fact that they've used the language already last year. They talked about it being in three. You know, I mean, Aaron, I think twice now has mentioned it originally being in 3.0. This was one I pulled out again. Him saying for 3.0, and then Disco saying no, correcting you. It's going to be 3.1. Then he's like, oh yeah, okay, 3.1. So there's the clear, he's like, at the end of the day, I firmly believe they've already probably got it already there. It's already on the roadmap. They already know it's coming. They've already been planning the best they can. They know this has to happen. So maybe it's like one of those painful pills you're just going to have to maybe take and just figure out what the aftermath of this is going to be, because I don't think there's going to be a clear understanding exactly what's going to happen. Because the way I look at it is why not, rather than doing all the ships, you could buy suddenly all the ships, they could do a drip effect. So you could potentially, we're going to introduce three ships that you're going to be able to buy in the game. You know, rather than all of them, we're going to say we're going to have three ships. It's going to be like an Aurora. You can buy a Freelancer, and you could buy, I don't know, the Starfarer, for example. You know, those three ships. You could make it so that the ships aren't that useful or something, but are still fun to try and own and to get. And then they could then work out how that plays out for them, if they see any money losses or anything like that, you know, or however. Or they could make three top-end expensive ships that we all have to try and work hard for.
With any business, you've still got to try and do summary reports. You've got to try and at least work out what you still have to have a projected idea of how that's going to impact your business. You can't just release something thinking, we'll just see what happens. Because if you go fucking bankrupt a week later, say, well, why did no one see this happening?
They will know exactly.
Suck it and see. You've got
how much they earn from it, though. They'll know what they earn earn from ship sales, non-concept ship sales, because concept sales will still continue. But yeah, they'll have an idea of how much they make from just ship sales, single ships or game, not game packages, because that will still continue, but single ships. And to be honest, in my opinion, it's dropped a lot. We get a little flux now and again, but because of the concerns with Star Citizen that a lot of people are seeing, the whole idea of buying more ships is kind of steadied anyway. People are waiting for more content before they spend more money. So I don't think it's going to be a great loss for them. It will be a loss, but concept ships are going to continue. Starter packages are going to, and I expect we'll see different variations and tiers of concepts of starter packages.
I agree with you, and I agree with Uncle talking in chat. I think it'll make them more money in the long run, to be honest, because more people will get involved in the game because they can now see that they can have ships by playing the game rather than...
Don't you think that will create an atmosphere of, I'll just buy a starter package, Aurora or Mustang,
that's gonna happen
buy anyway. The rest in game? It's
people should
anyway.
Do that. People that need to do that now. Exactly. That's what they should... If people are a bit concerned about the game, or even if they're not concerned, they just want to earn in the game, buy a starter package. Don't buy anything else. I highly recommend that over anything else, is just to buy the cheapest game package.
A completionist will buy anyway, you know what I mean? That's what you mean, basically. A completionist, someone that already owns 20k, 10k, 5k, maybe even £1,000 worth of ships, will buy more stuff anyway when he sees it. Yeah, I think maybe we're over that honeymoon period, and now...
I think it's all going to come with the webpage as well. With the, I mean, we'll talk about the webpage a little bit as well, but with the new upcoming webpage revamping, you know, streamlining, simplifying, could be another example of they've already kind of getting ready to roll this in. They're already implementing, you're starting to bring it more into the game. You're going to buy more stuff within the game. It's going to start to, you know, we will do, like you were saying, Mac, we're going to do the concept sales still. We're going to do all that stuff because people that know the game know that that's how we generate our revenue at the moment, and we still need that money. So people who love Star Citizen, still want Star Citizen to happen, will still support the game and still give them their money because we are a tight-knit community. However, we need to get more people to play the game. So what is better? When people have, if you can't attract people at the moment with the current situation, there is no other better way than saying, hey, by the way, if you spend £30, you can now buy these other ships. You can actually buy the ships in the game. You can now buy the ships in the game to get more people in. Do you know what I mean? To get new players into the game now. They're not going to...
Right there, yeah.
They're not going to, you know, they've already, they're like, well, I only want to spend 30 quid on it. I mean, there's other things, factors like the frame rates and the quality of the gameplay mechanics, all that stuff as well, which will limit. Sure. But knowing that you can actually buy some ships in the game, I think would make a big difference for a lot of new players. You know,
yeah. Captain Carrot makes a good point, actually, how having this 3-monthly update now is going to build confidence. I don't think we'll see an initial rise or increase in sales too much until they have the track record for these monthly updates. So I think 2019 is probably when we start. I think 2019 is a fiscal year for Star Citizen, but 2018 is the hype year for Star Citizen. We'll see a lot of people coming in and seeing like, okay, they're starting to deliver more. They're meeting the targets. Yes, things may be pushed back, but they're meeting the targets. And I think it will be a confidence builder this year to show that Star Citizen is true to what it's saying. It's the only reason why it was failing before is because it was more than they expected. It needed a lot more work. It was kind of like a real mindfuck of tech that was needed to be created. And they've now achieved that with 3.0.
They changed the game.
They have completely.
That's what they basically did. They changed the game.
And now it's just a case of showing and building a reputation as a solid game that is coming. It's not a thought. It's an actual reality. And that is what's going to show the evidence that it's going to work. And then 2019 is when they're going to start selling it as a make it. We'll see a fluctuation. Like, we'll see a fluctuation. We only have, nearly 2 million backers. We're going to see it go like that in 2019 at the...
Well, I'm not making any predictions. You can go ahead and make those predictions. That's fine. I'm going to stay well and truly away from the predictions. However, I will say that this year, in terms of what you're saying about building confidence, like last year, I expected what I was hoping they're going to do this year, last year. Okay. So, but I'm going to wipe the slate clean. I'm going to say, okay, 2017 was a freaky year. Crazy shit was going on. I think everyone's learned from this. 2018, I'm going to give you CRG a fresh slate to start again, like we're doing the show, restart, refresh. It's a great time to start again, and let's see how they progress. By the time we get to June, if they have missed their March, April window when they were first going to give us stuff, and I agree with Miz, what Miz was saying, that they've made it so it's limited the amount they have to do to help themselves. They've learned from their past mistakes, and they're focusing on just improving what we already have. They should hit that. And so hopefully that will... It's like banking some reliability and credibility with me and with the community. And then hopefully June, which is the big one for me, when they release, they're talking about releasing tier zero on mining, salvaging, mobile refueling, and repairing in game, as well as being giving the ability to players to create their own missions, like hiring mercenaries, transport for refueling missions and stuff. So I'm curious to see if that's going to be us to be able to transfer money between people.
Well, that is
the basics of that.
To do missions,
must
you have
be.
To have that.
They must did be. Say, didn't they, that also with that is to create your own missions, like hiring mercs, transport, and so that's going to be, I think, tier one of or tier zero of the service beacon. So we'll see that come into play, which allows you to hire people to put out a mission for people to accept. Hopefully, I mean, that is going to be the 3.2, I guess, would be the pinnacle, one of the main patches for Star Citizen this year, because it comes with the mechanics that are not just combat and all that sort of shit. It's going to be things that are worth that what people want to play, you know, like the mining, the salvaging, all these mechanics that people want to actually take part in. That's what's going to be pulling more people in, because at the moment it's just combat. Other than Madness, nobody really wants to play combat. So I'm joking.
I want to have all of it. I want to have combat.
I think we see more mechanics. That's like you said. That's because it's like when you play other early access games and things like that. In terms of people, they get released at different stages, and the amount of people that jump in and start playing it all depends on. Realistically, people want an early taste of the game, what they're getting. So when you get more of these features coming in, that's what will attract more people to come and play it, I think, because like they want something they're looking for.
No,
please. So if our names had beards had names, Ryan's would be called the comeback.
The what?
The comeback.
The comeback.
Because it's coming back. Comeback.
Yeah, I get it.
Then Madness is called the fish threat, because it's
the
like,
attempt. The attempt. It'd be more the attempt, really.
Then you have the D'Artagnan.
Oh yeah. D'Artagnan.
And this is just called
the Chuck Norris.
The Chuck Norris.
The Chuck.
The Chuck. I like that.
Love that stuff.
But, totally worth the interrupt, though, wasn't it?
Totally worth the interrupt. Thank you. It's all right. It's fine. We're completely
I feel like I'm like a dark room box here.
You're happy that I'm back? For one day, for now. But you're happy that I'm sharing my thoughts with you again, yeah?
It's wonderful. Yeah. Hang on, where's the mute button? Where's your mute button? Hang on. There you are. There's the mute button.
Yeah, it's really good. It's really good. So just put a sticky tape over him. It's fine.
Right, let's mute him. He's done now. Right, where was I? Where were we? Oh, yeah. So, thank you for the bits, Prisoner.
Where were we? I totally lost.
We're all about beards now. Fuck, gone crazy.
Where are we going to see beards in Star Citizen?
Oh, soon, I hope. I hope so. I really do hope we can get. But what the female character needs to come first. Like, come on, let's get that.
Let's get the girl in.
That's half the world. Half the world's population is female. Let's get some girls in. I know it's a space game, but come on.
It's all girls about play the girls
space
games. Month,
girls play space games as well.
The Golden Globes can do it. It's all about the girls. Let's get them in.
There's no mention in that
in the schedule report, though, which is a bit weird.
I know. I was disappointed. Again,
where
I was like,
that?
What's going on?
We need to ring up the gold, you know, the Hollywood actresses and say, look, excuse me, but the CIG are slacking. CIG. They're not putting the female model in. Female model in.
They are proper slacking.
We can give biomechanical address and give it a go.
Yeah, we could do. Yeah, for sure. We could put you in a dress.
I wouldn't be a good looking female. Come on, have you seen this?
No.
I think they would call that a grenade.
I'd have to drink a lot more slur. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, yeah.
Sure. But no,
Princess Leila in down here.
Where are they? These are, there's just a few. Like I said, there's two things on the schedule report that I was a little bit like, where are these information? Where is this information? Well, there's a few more than that, but generally two was, where are the girls? And where like I said, where are the girls? And where is the, like I was saying, about buying ships this year? That's what I wanted to know. I wanted to know about buying ships in game, and I wanted to know where the female characters are, because that for me is quite a big stuff. There's lots of other things like we could talk about, but for me, that's my...
The cockpit of the Gladius.
That's my two things, you know? That's my two things. The cockpit of the Gladius, yeah, no, that's we've let that one slide. That's
there,
in the past.
Is there a that chicken
was,
in the back of
that was on a, that was on a, that was on a, that was on another show, something called the Addicted chicken, Podcast. Yeah.
Mac chokes
know.
The chicken while he's not looking when on screen.
Jesus Christ, Miz.
Don't put it on the stream, Mac.
I think a naked board gamer should be implemented for.
That is a chicken.
No, he comes back with females. Tissue. He comes back with a really tissue in his hands after looking at
wiping his hands.
Chicken in the I background. Nice.
What are you frozen doing with a chicken? Chicken?
You've been a choking it. Is that a chicken? Is that a chicken behind you?
No, that that's spillage? That's Hey Hey.
Hey Hey.
Hey
yeah,
Hey.
From Moana.
Hey Hey. Moana. Okay. All right.
Tell me you know what Moana is.
We were just commenting on choking the chicken. That was...
That's obviously what he's been doing. That's why he's come back. It's like, oh, I'm spilling.
The fact that you come back with toilet roll as well.
I'm prepared.
Like, Jesus Christ.
Matt, don't you guys have anything else than toilet roll in the house to clean it up? You might want to grab a... How do you call it?
Like a baby wipe.
Careful, she might put a jacket potato in there.
Yeah, fucking hell. I don't know anyone that's managed to... set fire to a potato in a microwave. Yeah.
just roll some toilet roll around it.
Yep, but that seems to work.
I mean, people are listing out some of the female like streamers out there. There is a lot of female streamers for Star Citizen.
Even Star's female.
And they
and she's
want
on the base radio.
Well done, Mac.
I know a female.
Woo. I know a female. But there's some new people. Like there's a new Vamps was. I gave her a copy of Star Citizen to play because I was like, we need more female players. Better. But the first thing is they go, oh, where can I change my character to be a female character? And it's like, it's not in the game anymore. They're like, okay, fine. You know, they can deal with it. But
they could probably sell a shit ton of copies just by sticking the female model in.
Yeah. I mean. Girls
I know a lot that won't play without that. So,
from what I understand, they're still sort of building the male model to the full scale exactly what they want it to be, and then they're going to add. Then they're going to just basically take that and make a female model using the same.
Okay, so when you talk about the scale, so they must, but they must know by now in terms of the physical heights and widths that there must be a box that they can say the character.
Sorry,
can go
I don't
no
mean,
bigger.
I don't mean scale. No I don't wider. Mean like scale and size of the character. I just mean. All the animations they need, all the movements.
The facial animations. But what I've heard is that they're going to use a Supermax face scan for the female models.
I would make a lovely lady.
I heard that too. But I don't know. I don't know what the holdup. I mean, I know it's a whole new set of animations and character creation, but I'm like, surely they could create a base. Surely they could... have a basic character by now. I don't know. But I mean, hey, I'm not a game developer, so hey, whatever.
It's because of they don't want to waste time doing them simultaneously. They get one fully complete and then apply the same techniques and everything and make sure that the female character then has the exact same amount of everything that the male character has. So it's a case of they could develop them both side by side.
And then, finish one. Yeah. It's just a different way of doing it. I mean, personally, I would have done both simultaneously, but that means a bigger number of people and much harder, probably bigger.
They probably should have done, to be fair, but yeah, it's just a choice they made, I guess.
It's a choice they made. Anyway, that's just, we can't control that.
We're drifting away. I think a bearded female would be a good one, though. We can scan in Conchita. I don't know if you remember that one from the Song Festival.
You know, identifying as a bearded female is a thing in space. That's for sure.
It should be a thing.
It should be a thing. September is the next one. So you go June.
Don't put it that low, Matt. We don't need to know.
Whoa!
Completely fucked up the beer.
And there goes Madness's channel. He's now banned for life.
I would never show
massive,
that.
Massive. Oh god, it'd be like that picture of those two girls with that huge fisting thing that was hanging behind them. Oh, they never live that down. Moving on. Did you ever see
that?
Please
one of
tell
those?
Me you saw that. Yeah, it was one of those things. They sat behind them, hat, looking very happy.
I think I've seen it on Twitter.
You've not seen that one? I'll send it to you later. September.
No.
Rachel will be like, oh, what's that? Who's that? What did she say? She won't even notice it.
She won't even notice it. It's so subtle. I think they didn't even notice it. That's why they posted the picture by mistake. September, we have late delivery. We got September. They're going to be reducing another major long-term goal, the object container streaming. So this is the one we were talking about, improving quality for you, the object container stuff. Mm. That's going to be interesting. This technology will allow them to start expanding the Stanton system with additional destinations while managing our memory usage much better. In this delivery, we would like to start introducing mechanics of how you stake and file land claims and the gameplay that comes with this feature. The release will also continue to consolidate and polish all the new features in the past milestone. So they'll be just improving stuff as well.
It's interesting saying that, I mean, because that involves like the Pioneer, wouldn't it? Or unless they're going to do other ways of giving you a base.
No. It's not about building. It's about claiming.
Yeah, but it says the mechanics that come with that, which is like having the security to protect your land.
I think it more means going to the offices, like you stake the claim, you stake scanning, placing the beacon, and then going and to the offices and reporting it. It's not about building and stuff.
The actual mechanic of claiming your piece of the moon.
That's a good point, though. People will be able to claim a piece of land before they can.
And then you'll be able to give it to your loved one and say, look, I bought you a piece of the moon.
Merry Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
What's this? It's land.
It's land? It's a big fucking chunk of
the
moon.
They'll give you a fucking sleeping bag.
Yeah, I would totally just do that. Yeah. I need more tissue. Sorry.
Fuck me, you already used the whole bug roll.
Jesus Christ. They brought him
on. Use a towel.
Pro streamer. It was a screen go and it's like gone. Bye bye. Disconnected.
He's just trying to advertise for DX Razor. He's partnered with DX Razor now.
I just gotta get up a second. My back hurts.
I'll give him a little logo. Give him a little logo pimp. Beep.
Are you advertising for DX Razor today, Ryan?
You what?
Are you advertising for DX Racer today? Is that why you did they tell you to get up a couple of times during this podcast? So
That's like $3,000 I've just earned right there.
It slowly moves the tissue, put the tissue packaging past the screen, then the beer can slowly moves past the screen.
I'm the project closer.
T-shirt slowly past.
Is that a chicken in a bag? Is that what it is?
Chicken in a bag.
Chicken in a bag.
That's awesome.
Probably like £3. Chicken in a bag.
I'm liking that. That's cool. So we were talking about the first thing is the object container streaming. So would somebody like to clarify what that actually is?
No.
Okay, fine. Moving on to the next thing. Where does it show on it?
Is this somebody who would be knowledgeable,
but maybe this is the wrong show for that.
It's the kind of, from what I understand, it's something like an object contains a certain thing that if you I can't fucking explain it. I kind of have an understanding of it, but when I try and explain it, it just sounds like nonsense.
Anyone in chat wants to volunteer giving us the rundown of what object container actually is, the OBS? Because I just think of OBS, or OCS. OBS.
Madness, just put a random video on in the background and Mac probably knows what he's talking about then. Just put it on.
That's a cheap one from
2017, that one, bringing that one back into 2018. All right, then. Well, until somebody tells us what it is.
It's like the server sharing thing. Isn't that what that is? So, like, you're sending data from the cross servers.
Yeah. Isn't that a way of bringing everyone into a similar server where they can...
Yeah, so you're all, like, on the one server, but you still split. That only shows people that need to be shown. Like, this is just bullshit. We're trying to black our way through it. I know what it is. If we don't know, don't guess.
Well, if we don't know exactly what it is,
we don't know what it is exactly. It's too technical.
But it's if someone could do a general roundabout kind of pop-up version. it makes things better. Yes, exactly. It allows them to start expanding the Stanton system with additional destinations, which I was kind of like curious, like how that technology would enable you to expand. But I'm guessing because what you're saying in terms of if you are keeping it so that it's localized to you, then
that's what we're saying. The data that you're getting at the moment is everywhere when you're logged in. So why they can't expand it, because then it's loading even more data in. So when cut that data
down, we are all getting this. Like anytime anything changes in the current game, everyone has the same changes, regardless of where you are. Basically, if you're like at if you're at Yella and something changes at Levski, you don't need to know about that because you're not in that location. So it will
it's not within visual view. Things.
Yes, exactly. Thank you.
I think you want is at the moment, as the servers are set up now, and hopefully I'll explain it right. If there's a ship exploding on Olizar and you are on Levski, you would feel the impact of that explosion, so to say, on your frame rates, because it's doing that. But it shouldn't show that. It should only show what's in your visual range. And I think they're trying to contain those things to certain areas. Separate instances, so only if you are in the range of that instance that it would load in for you, basically.
So is that a bit like Miz? Like today, we were in the lift, and I think it was Edison was saying that we were in the lift, but we got stuck in the lift; it wasn't working. But I was like, "Well, why don't somebody at the top press the button, and that will bring the lift up?" We were stuck in the lift together, you know, it's one of those.
No, it's more
it was getting a bit, but and then we're like, well, but then he said that they couldn't do it. It didn't work. They weren't able to because it was a separate object container for us versus what they would have. So we were stuck.
I think it's more to do with zones, because the lift is an actual in-the-game lift. It's not a loading screen. It's not a case of you get in the lift and now it loads a new area. That lift is physically moving within the area. So the instance is like a radius or a square of that area, and then another square of a different, you know, that's so basically.
I think it's like Zeb Webster says, if you can't see it, you shouldn't know it even exists.
Yeah, so you don't need to see that sort of shit.
You don't need to know what's going on in Port Olisar if you're on Yella.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is I'm just trying to break it down as a mini example that the lift was like a separate thing for us versus for somebody else. So it was
but it's not though. It's not. It's the lift is in the same instance as whoever is around that area. Because the lift is physically done in the game.
But they couldn't press the button to make our lift come up and we would come out of it, though. That was what they were saying. But I guess
that's because it's a glitch. That's a glitch. That's the bug at the moment, is that the lift doesn't work properly. Okay. But no, you're all in the same instance.
You get teleported as well.
Because Grim Hex
actually blow up. That's what you got to ask yourself. Because if no one's loading the object container, no one knows it's blowing up, do they? So.
Yeah, it's a case of culling things that don't need to be loaded if no one's around.
Makes sense.
If that someone comes sense. Into the proximity of it, it'll render. It'll come in. So it's about the servers being, or the server, not having to load things that are just unnecessary.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's good. So that means that they're going to expand the Stanton systems with additional destinations. So are we expecting Microtech? Do
you think Edison loves you, Mac, but you're wrong.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. That's the way I understand it.
So will you? So with what are we expecting expansion wise? What do you think?
Well, Stanton. It's got to be hopefully ArcCore, Hurston, Microtech, the satellites, you know, the moons of that. Hopefully, it's everything at once. But it could be a case of seeing one planet, moons, another planet.
Do you think
moons.
We'll get a planet?
Yeah, we've seen Hurston. Yes, definitely.
Yeah,
we've seen it. We've seen parts of it.
We've seen the progression, and it looks really good.
Okay. So I'm just curious. I was just thinking, do you think we will get a planet this year? I mean, I hope we get a planet this year. That would be amazing. I mean, the end of the year, if we're lucky. If I'm being honest, I don't expect it anywhere near. I expect it maybe December if we're lucky.
It could be. I mean, they want to get object streaming completed first before they really endeavor into planets. Because if I'm right, although I might be wrong in what I'm saying,
Edison,
they need these planets. You know, they need object containers before they can start adding more to the system.
Well, that's what it said.
I can see Mac go to the toilet tonight, and there's no role.
Well, that's what I was. Spaceship training wheels. I was thinking that as well, because at the moment we were in, me and Miz were in earlier, as we were not no longer stuck in the lift together. We were actually in this in the ship, and he was in a separate ship, and he was taken off from Molossar, and I saw the comm ability to see his name, give me Miz, and there's that button that you would naturally be able to then communicate. So I'm hoping that that will come in this year, where we'll actually be able to do like in-game.
Well, that come with the Spectrum integration? Didn't they?
Yeah, that's more turbulent end. And we've got the update on the website, which I'm sure we'll talk about soon. But the
we'll talk about it in a bit.
That is separate to the development of Star Citizen. So, strangely enough, it's more turbulent side. I think we'll see that sooner than we think. That should hopefully come in soon, where we can start actually talking in-game and integrating Spectrum and the website with the game. So if you're offline, you want to join your friend, you can be like, where are you guys? And they'll get a ping in game without them to jump out of the game and say, we're at core, whatever, and you can just go straight there or whatever. So yeah, it's, I think comms and VoIP, FIP, that sort of thing will come pretty soon this year. First, second patch, I don't know, but that's separate to the game development. So we may see it. Well, I expect at the end of this month when we get the update, highlighting everything we're going to see, they will mention Turbulence work on Spectrum and the website and VoIP and stuff.
Yeah.
But that is so necessary. Jumping on Discord is cool, but like I played with so many subscribers, it was hard to talk and listen at the same time because everyone talks at once. When you've got proximity voicing, it'll be fine because you can just run away from everyone.
Like you were doing today on stream, you jumped in the Reliant with...
Akai.
Was it Akai? Yeah. And like you said, you just sit next to me. It'd be so much nicer if you could just turn around and like push the button.
Yeah.
Right, where do you want to go? Rather than...
Just having a general conversation while you're traveling will make the game so much more fun.
Well, same even today, me and Madness, because he wasn't on Discord, first of all, so I jumped in the back and he just thought I was some stranger that was going to shoot him in the back of his cutlass, which I probably was. But
yeah, I mean, exactly. You need to be able to have the button. You can say, talk to each other and just at least start an initial open dialogue together and talk to each other.
Yeah,
in game. So
the biggest thing that we need is one of these sticks, these electricity sticks that you use to hurt cows. If someone gets in your ship, you can poke them with it, and you just, you know, get the fuck out.
Or just a taser gun.
I was pushing someone out the other day because he just ran in, and it wasn't one. It wasn't rammed, and it wasn't. I think it was Big Ripley that was with me and the drones. And we had to push some guy out with the three of us because it wasn't one of us.
Is that how you do it?
Yeah, yeah. You can push someone away when he's offline and stuff.
That's not pushing him away, so that's...
You know what I mean. That's what Madness and him were doing in the lift.
Yeah, I bet. Yeah.
Someone was biting the pillow.
What, pushing something out, was that what you were saying?
No, pushing something in.
Pushing something in, okay, sorry.
Move on quick.
let's move this childish conversation on. So that, but you're right though, in the sense that being able to like taser or be able to stun somebody and then literally manually drag their body off of, if someone, I mean, personally, you just kill someone, but if you're in an amnesty zone, how much fun would it be to be able to taser people?
I can't wait to see that weapon.
You can't kill them. You can't kill them, but you can knock them out, and you don't get a crime stat or anything. You're just a nuisance. Everyone just running around tasering everyone in the back.
Like EMP troll. It's going to be the same, but it'll be like FPS instead.
Be so much. Or like do the choke, like CQC, like from Mass Effect. Not Mass Effect. Some Metal Gear Solid, like going around choking and doing like hand-to-hand combat and stuff in ships. That would be so much fun. Sorry, it's just me.
No, it's fine.
I love all that stuff, but yeah, I mean,
the five finger death punch.
The five finger, but that's the schedule, by the way, guys. That's the schedule. December. I think they've left it so that it's kind of open. I think they're very smart to leave December open. Really, if you actually look at it, it's very. We'll add a few things to this, and we'll kind of add a few more things to this career choices and expand the Stanton system again. I think they've left that one so that the runoff of everything else that's probably a little bit later, maybe in September or whatever, we'll run into December, to be honest. So
I like how they've put, though, now that our streaming tech has been tested and can support a huge amount of it. It's like...
We know that those 3 months are going to perfect.
Yeah. We haven't actually tested it yet. It's coming in September, so... But they obviously are working on it and have a certain understanding that we don't yet because we haven't seen it. So.
Soon.
Yeah.
That's a good point, actually. Someone just raised
it. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if they flesh it out more with the more in detail, or whether they'll keep it left a bit more vague. so they get more choice, you know, more option of not hitting deadlines, or like you said, surprising us with stuff, saying, look, we've managed to do this.
Yeah.
And I think that in some ways that's a better way to do it. But
yeah, definitely.
I think two updates this year of note, and then we're going to have two kind of smallish just improvements on what we get from those two.
I hope we get some, if it's not what they consider major content, I hope we do get something in those months, because it's quite a long wait till the first.
I hope so.
It's March soon, though.
Some people keep thinking that Squadron 42 might come out this year. The first chapter. What do you guys think?
Chris Roberts saw that 2 years ago.
They didn't put a release date, which makes me think no. Nah. I think they're likely gonna, when they come up with the release date, they're gonna have at least 6 months of advertising first, at the very least. So if they do come up with a release, they could still do it this year, but
maybe the October, December.
Yeah, that would be the window they go for if it's to the point where they didn't.
Here's a question. Do you think that they would give us, you know, like other games give you like a little demo to play, like the vertical slice type of thing? Do you think they'll give us that this year to play for Squadron 42?
No, I don't think so. I wish they did. I really, really want to play that, but I don't think so. I think it'll just be now the game's released, go for it.
We're not in the age of demos anymore, are we? Let's face it. No company does demos, really.
They should bring that. They should be the company. Jay Lee, tell them.
I miss demos.
Yeah.
On CD. On CD.
Make PC great again. Let's bring back fucking demo discs. We want a demo.
Please do.
Yeah, floppy. Yeah, that would be. That would bring back some memories anyway, that's for sure. Thank you for the bits. Right, we've got. Right, so we'll move on to the. What's happened?
The next bit.
Broke it again.
Demos. Yeah, bring back floppy disks while you're at it. Why not?
My time in Portia had a demo.
Sorry, don't know what happened then. Let's go to the webpage. Webpage.
Sexy.
What do you guys think? Webpage. I'll bring up some pictures in a second, so just give me.
Well, they said it was going to be out with 3.0, so found that one.
What do you got? Yeah, I know. Yeah. Well, and they said that the updates
pretty soon though.
The information on the webpage would be improved, and the stats would be 100% correct, and all of this, and that turrets. Chris Roberts said turrets is working fantastic. There's a lot of things they say that I kind of go, yeah, right, whatever.
But no, I think it means it's probably pretty close compared to, you know, because they obviously thought that they could get it out with 3.0.
So we're talking about the website,
the web page. Let's. I've got a little video from the just to show kind of like some of the bits. I might break the video down slowly so we can go over the frames of it.
It looks like the main importance is making it more user friendly. For people who, like, basically making it so it's to the point where those who don't know how to handle it know instantly, like instinctively, how to use it. The hardcore backers or the diet, you know, will already they'll just figure it out because they just spend hours trying to do that sort of stuff. It's the people who are so new to the game that are like, what they need to do is get a lot of people in that have never touched the game, never heard of the game, look at the website and think, right, well, what's that like? Come up with the top priority questions and then just answer them as simply as possible, which I hope they've done.
Hopefully,
yeah. I mean, as long as it's easy to grasp.
It looks pretty. I certainly said that. It's looking like a lot of modern games have got now. A load of games are looking much more like that. You scroll through, there's a lot less information just bombarded you on, like, we've got currently on the front screen.
And there's a lot more focus on new players.
This is what you're looking at. The only thing is it's still a bit confusing. Probably not once you start actually clicking buttons, I suppose, but on very first look, because, like, most people are going to hear this game probably, I don't know, I suppose it depends what you hear it about, but the fact that it's having two names and stuff like that, it's kind of... So that you see Squadron 42, and you go, well, what's
that?
Yeah,
now splitting that.
Because I've come here for Star Citizen, what's the fuck Squadron 42? And the other way around. And like getting to the PU, getting to Squadron 42, it still sounds a little bit like, well, what the fuck do you mean by that? But without seeing the website and seeing what information they have on like the hover over type thing, that might explain it a little bit easier that way.
I mean, I naturally get nervous with hovering over thing web page, if I'm being honest. Yeah. I always get a little bit nervous with them because it's usually like I look at it for ages and I kind of move the mouse up and then nothing comes down, as it were, and you're just like, oh for fuck's sake, where's this? And then usually you get there, but I was generally quite pleased with what I saw.
I think one of the best things overdue. Is the mobile interaction.
Yeah. 100% agree with you.
It's one of the best things because I mean, the amount of times I just heard an explosion. I assume it's a firework. But
are you sure he's not your missus cooking another potato? Jacket potato mark two.
She's sitting there with a potato on her face.
I didn't catch a light. It just exploded.
Most of the time that I'm looking at the website, other than at my desk, on the desktop, is in bed or having a shit. So having mobile work, you know, so it works properly on mobile, you're not having to press these little buttons and zoom in to try and get it on. That is good. And in modern age, it needs to be mobile friendly from the offset, to be fair. So
I can imagine when you look at the phone and it's easier to find things on the Chris Roberts website than anywhere else, then yeah, then you got a problem, man.
I think, but to a degree, you're right. I think a lot of more people are mobile now, so
always
like,
right.
You're going to be seeing, you know, a lot more people are going to look at the website from a mobile device in the first place because it might be where they hear about it.
When I try and tell people that when I'm pissed in a pub and I'm like, oh, have you ever Star Citizen? Like, I've never heard of it. What? Tell me. It's a lot of shit because it doesn't look good.
Well, Squadron 42. But what's the website then? No, it's not Star Citizen. No, it's not Squadron 42. Yeah. What is it? Robert Space Industries. What?
I think 2016 and 17. I think the mobile usage of websites was something that was a standard. You know, it became a real standard over the last 2-3 years. You know, so we needed to get that in as soon as possible on Star Citizen. It's what you'd say. People want to check it on their phones, you know, people want to show other people, you know, and say, okay, this is it.
The way I look at it is if you and I, as amateurs, could probably put together a better web page for mobile phones in about an hour using some existing bits of technology and kit on other, you know, I don't know, streaming or web pages that do that type of thing than the Star Citizen one. You know, we could do it in probably an hour and actually probably have it make it look reasonably good and quite informative and quite clean and simple. So
what you don't want to forget, it's mixed in with Star Citizen itself, though. If you buy a ship on the website, it tells you in the game what needs to happen as well.
I understand that, you know, it's more complex.
There's a lot of content management behind it.
But in terms of the overall look of it, I mean, I'm just saying that just the way it looked, they could have cleaned it up donkeys ago.
They said, which is so important and true, is that it's a AAA game. They need to get a AAA website. They cannot have a shoddy, shitty website because they have a game that looks amazing. They come onto the website and you're like, I'm used to it, so I don't know what the actual new experience is, but they must come to it and be like, what the fuck am I supposed to? Like, the amount of questions as content creators we get that are like, how does it work? Proves.
Crytek even had a better website than them.
I watched new players. I watched new streamers. Like, so I usually go down and check out the new streamers sometimes. And I've come across at least 3 or 4 people, and I just watch them struggle to figure out. And I'm there in chat going, trying to type it, you know, and I'm like, I can't write an essay on Twitch, you know what I mean, for them to understand it. So then I'm going, do you have Discord? And then they're looking at me like I'm some sort of dodgy weirdo that's like,
you are a dodgy,
you know, what are you doing? Where? Yeah, well, okay, fair enough, I am. But still, they're like, why are you, you know, wanting to come onto Discord? I don't have Discord. Why do you want to come onto my Discord? Oh, I don't know. I just want to tell you in 5 seconds. Yeah, then I am. Do you know who I am? I just want to tell you in 5 seconds.
You know what I have to write. Even us, and I don't know if I can speak for you guys, but even myself, when I get onto the website sometimes, you need to think too long because you're like, oh, what do I need to click again? Instead of click, 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 click. I'm like, I'm looking at that top bar and I think, where the fuck was this again? Was it this one? Oh no, there it is. You know, and as soon as that is gone,
what one?
It's a lot better. Which one? That one.
Okay, so I'm just going to go through the initial pages very quickly for the webpage because I'm interested about it. So we've got join the verse on the left, which is simple. It's broken it down into three.
What's interesting in that also just going to highlight is it says don't show me again on that. So that's going to be like a I don't know what the actual main page will be.
True. I've noticed that. That's very strange. That's like the initial time, the first time, which I don't think that's a good idea because you'll be like, I only have one option here. Join the PU.
It's also the whole, when it says join the universe and start the adventure, both of those mean nothing. If you've never heard of the game as such, what do you mean by join the
get
universe?
Get rid of this.
Isn't that the same thing?
Get rid of that. Definitely.
I like it though, because you have the Star Citizen one, join the universe. You have Squadron 42, start
you know
the adventure.
That. If you
from the artist's perspective,
it.
This is pretty. I think it's pretty
it
well
looks
done.
Nice. It looks nice, but it's not about looking nice. It's about being user friendly and looking nice. And the trouble is, people are gonna like as long as they. I mean, don't get me wrong. They just won't tick up. Don't show me this again. Hopefully, but when you go through to the home screen, should have all this information anyway. It should. Give
I
you
think
the
there will still screen. Be an option in the top where
it probably will,
where
but
you
not
click on the different ones.
I think what they need to make sure they do is when they. I mean, I'm sure they do this, but you know, it's easy to forget that people don't always do it. It's just go grab some random people. Go get your mum or some, you know, different age ranges from older to younger and just get them to test it out.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at as someone that doesn't have a clue what Star Citizen is, and it just doesn't seem to make sense that, well, because if you've heard of Star Citizen, you think, well, join the universe, that's Star Citizen, but what the hell's start the adventure? Isn't that, like, you would think that means the same thing.
Yeah, I'm nowhere close to that website because if she sees what I spend on that game, she'll break my legs. I tell you that.
Why would you have start the adventure in the middle and not like as if you were reading? Anyway, that's just me. But anyway, let's move on. So the next one that they come up with on the video was obviously join the verse, blah blah blah. They show us obviously start the adventure. Mark Hamill.
Mark, what the fuck was that?
Breaking the silence.
So we've got they're going to drop down here, join the verse, start the adventure, follow the development.
So I'm presuming this page you're on now is going to be when if you tick don't show me that, this will be the homepage.
Yeah, this will be the homepage. Yeah. So play alpha 3.0, it says on the bottom. We've got about the game, the universe, how to play, media, and then join the verse, start the adventure, follow, and then we've got shop, support, spectrum, and account.
What they need to have is when you hover over like start the adventure, it needs to say enter the Star Citizen single player campaign, blah blah, or join the universe. Take a look at the vast universe that spans, you know, that's just to sort of give an impression as to what it is.
Yeah, because on that they said launch. You just changed it now. Launch Star Citizen or something. I can't remember what it said. And then underneath it said no, launch Spectrum. Sorry. And then underneath in brackets it said our community forums. So you know what that is. Although Spectrum, you think what's Spectrum, but at least you can see underneath community forums where it says you know, join the universe, it should say underneath our MMO or whatever you're calling it, and then under Squadron 42 our single, put in brackets, our single player campaign. Just little things like that to make it more obvious when you're seeing it straight away, what am I clicking at and what does it mean? Squadron 42 or a single player campaign, or let's look at that, just
saying, like a subtitle,
because otherwise you're presuming people know what Star Citizen means and what Squadron 42 means, and they don't. Not when they first jump on that website.
They're they may have heard of one.
They've come there from one or the other.
Yeah, exactly.
And so it doesn't make sense. And like you said already, it's confusing because you're going to Robert Space Industries in the first place. So it's you're getting all these different names and conflicts.
Lots of different names.
A little bit
lots
in your face.
Names.
Yeah, it's I can see another revamp coming.
but here's the question, like when you first asked, Ms. Major's a good point, when I first was looking for a Star Citizen, I went www.starcitizen.com and I didn't get nothing, you know, it's Robert Space Industries, you know, it's
that's
like,
what Google is for,
that's what you do, and then you go to Google and then you figure out where it is, and that's fine, it didn't take very long, it was like 5 seconds, but it was like that, what you were saying about that again, it's another little barrier there, a little bit of an obvious thing that could be fixed. So yeah, I agree with you on the naming stuff. MMO, single player campaign, makes sense. You know, it's pretty.
A Homo sapien will lose his interest within seconds when he can't find something. So a second, split
that's
second.
You know, working in like the retail industry, I know how thick the average population is, and you need to spell out everything.
What?
Huh? You need to literally put things as plain and simple, black and white. This is this, this is this. Otherwise, people are going to be like...
Because this is... You know, this is again another example. They've got Step Into a New World, A Ship for Every Ambition, and Plan Your Journey.
What does that all mean?
What does it mean?
Now, I've seen it, but Step Into a New World, Plan Your Journey. What does that mean?
Well, he clicks on it. So here you go, Planning Your Journey. I click on it. And then I don't know if this is a fit. I mean, we're speculating quite heavily on what we've just seen.
They're like titles that don't mean anything to people.
Explore. Yeah. So five ships in this class. Exploration.
It's trying to make it look nice, but you're forced to click everything. And although they want you to eventually click everything on the page, that's not what people do. People want to know what they're clicking.
To be honest, I like the clicking idea. To be honest,
it's kind of making people choose a certain path. Rather than being able to do everything, it's kind of making you think, well, if I buy that, I mean, all they need is what it is, how to buy the game, so your basic starter package and the other options, and then go into details. We don't really know what the final site's like, so okay.
Yeah, I know, but I think it's I'm just going through what we've seen because I think it's we haven't got a huge amount else to talk about, but no, it's fine. I like the visuals though; it's beautiful. Again, it's that whole visuals, but then you've got to get past the visuals.
Be a lot better.
There is a very strong message in it though. Be who you are.
Thank you.
What does that mean?
That's very very deep.
No, on that website, be who you are. I think that's a very.
So if you want to drink schlur, you should just say fuck you all.
Yeah. You know, if you want to go to
how to play,
if you want to go to Lloyd's Bar and address, you know, be who you fucking are. You know, just do it.
Well, this is interesting. So how to play? So choice matters. In Star Citizen, you have the freedom to decide how. To make your way in the galaxy, whether you're a simple merchant, a fearsome outlaw, or ruthless mercenary.
There he goes again.
But that's better, though. I get that one because it says how to play, and then you know what that is. It's going to be a little guide on how you play the game. And I think that title says what it is, whereas the other two don't.
Yeah. Where it's got a hanger.
About the game. Perfect. Universe. Well, what do you mean about the game?
Yeah, I like this. This was my favorite page. Because it's got the tutorial. Here you go. Movement control. Tutorial. They should have flight. Tutorial. Basic flight buttons, blah, blah, blah. Tutorial, you know.
That's it. Without reading the description, you can look at that and instantly know, right, that's for movement. That's for hanger. That's what you need. A lot more of that. Pop into your face what exactly what it is. That's all I'm saying.
And then obviously showing us that it's going to be obviously for your... We were talking about for the mobile phone back, so that's really cool, and I agree. I think this is fantastic to have it on. Much easier to use buttons and stuff, you know, just so much better. Moby Glass and all that stuff. So this is good. And then now this is Schwester. I'm not quite sure what that means.
Schwester, which means sister in German.
Sister. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know why it says Schwester, but
okay. And then this is. I guess this is Spectrum.
Another 500 quid from DX Racer, Mac, eh?
And that was it, yeah.
Big round.
he's ripping. Hang on, this is very good.
That's why I keep leaving.
So I'm guessing
this page is about where the develop. They said there's going to be an element of it about the development of.
Is the development.
So stuff, this is an update on the development where they. That's the development broken down into different things and how they are on it, I think.
I mean, I'm going to say that looks like the most confusing piece of shit I've already seen. Again, I'm already like, wow, that looks really confusing to me as a layman. I'm like, lots of boxes. It looks neat, but it's like lots of boxes. And I'm just like, oh, God. But I'm sure it's simple once I kind of figure it out. I don't know if that's for the average Joe. That's probably for more the nerds out there, I guess, that want to know this stuff.
It's more when you nerds, are we?
Well, it's for anyone buying a particular ship, isn't it? Like, if you've ever bought... You always have an interest, a slight interest in every ship, but when you own a ship, you read everything about that ship.
But that doesn't...
Finite details, and that's what it
says.
But
that doesn't make sense in terms of, like, it says, say the Vandal Blade. Then it says ships and vehicles too.
Well, it's just placeholders. It's placeholders. It's like Lorem Ipsum. Yeah. It's just an idea of what's going to happen.
I'm foreseeing, like we were saying, a continual need to do new web pages again. Just like I just feel like I do think this is they're going to have to go through many more iterations of this, just even though based on what we've seen. I really do think
The more they add to the game, they'll need to do that. The more they bring into the game, the new stuff they add to the game, they'll need to keep updating stuff as time goes on, because it's like the controls. We see these control changes because so much more is changing in the game. It's always going to iterate until they get to the point where they're like, right, okay, this is kind of final. Let's just leave it at that. I expect.
I mean, if there's anything, anyone, I mean, that's pretty much the webpage stuff really covered, and ATV in terms of what they covered, which was a really short ATV. I'm hoping we get back. When do you think we're going to get back to the studio reports? Next week? This week?
Well, I don't know. They are going to have Reverse the Verse is coming back. I don't know if you saw that.
Reverse the Verse is coming back.
Yeah. Cool.
Is that like a? It's not an every week thing, though, is it? Or is it?
Yeah, I think so.
I think what they do with isn't Reverse the Verse the Friday thing they do, or is that?
Yeah, it's on Friday.
So they'll swap it out with like we have the happy hour, we have Reverse the Verse. I expect they'll just swap things out. I know the law posts are changing. They're reducing the law because they're focusing more on Star Citizen writing and 3.0 writing and Squadron 42. So we'll see a decrease, but they have a lot of backlog, so we may see a change. They did a post about that. Lost my train of thought because my screen's flickering like crazy. Talk amongst yourselves.
What he said.
Yes,
no, so exactly. I think Reverse the Verse is basically like where they go over what you saw in ATV and they answer quote like if people ask questions and stuff like that on it. What does this mean? What does that mean? They then go back on it. And they say, well, this is what he meant by this, and this is what he meant by that, and answer those questions.
Yeah.
Yeah. So happy hour's gone then, so that no longer means we'll no longer get developers making stuff for us, like the space whale.
Yeah, I know.
I don't think any of these necessarily potentially gone, as in terms of they did it before, they kind of, it might be you'll see it as a one-off now and again, or, you know, if they show a reason for it, they'll bring it in, or, you know.
They did a poll, didn't they, about what we all liked, what we didn't like, and so forth. So they'll take the majority of what we did like and produce more either of that or similar to that ilk. And then the stuff that got the least votes, they'll just be like, whatever. This fucking monitor. Jesus.
How many times is he going to get up? Why don't you just...
This fucking monitor's flickering. It's still... Wow. A DVL, DDLA, D whatever the connection is. It's not a HDMI connection, this old monitor. So it's like...
Oh, you got one of those like old VGA ones.
Are you running an NVIDIA by any chance? Because I had a similar issue over the last few days that my monitor is going black and then coming back.
Are you seeing like lots of green dots and then it goes
and lots of blue dots on the screen, yeah. I had the same issue. I think it's a driver issue from NVIDIA.
I'm going to buy another Asus.
I swapped out my HDMI cable though and it... Stop doing it. So
I don't have HDMI. It's VGA only.
I've read it on a forum. grab a different VGA cable and try it with that.
I think I'll fucking have to. Carry on. Ignore me.
I feel you. I've got an old monitor. This is the one I'm looking at right now. Is my old spare monitor, which doesn't even do HD. It's like so old. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's so bad. But it's free, so fuck it.
We're living in the Stone Age.
We are. We use what we can. If it's not broken, why fix it? But yours is clearly broken.
No, it's time to
fix it. Oh, is it still? Is it fixed now?
Yes. Yeah, it's not flickery anymore. Look at that. Nice. Another 3 years out of that one, I think.
Miss, do you see the similarities here?
Awesome.
Oh, my God.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to pull up a few little things. Hang on, what have we got?
I'm giving it to you as well, Ryan, by the way.
What was we talking about?
Mrs. Brother in the DM on there.
If no one's watched this, this is actually quite a good video. I'm just going to link it in chat. I'm not going to talk about it, but it's this gentleman that's done like a hardware guide on YouTube. Which is really, really good. So a lot of people having problems with their computers or understanding like what kind of performances you need to play the game, this is really good. It's on Reddit, but some people may not have access or like to go to Reddit, so I'll do the hard work for you. So there you go. That is a really good link to Alpha 3.0 hardware guide. Well worth watching. I watched it and it's 20 minutes long. It's well worth it. Just to see the performance and stuff, what computers you need and stuff. I'm trying to think of what other good things we have. Hang on. Yeah, we've got two really cool things. One is the hang on, where was it? I'm gonna try and dig it out now. Yes, here it was. Mm-hmm. Here it was. It was the Arrivals thing, which I never did notice this. I didn't notice this before, but on the there's an Arrivals and Departures board. If I can zoom in here, and so they all have potentially your name. That's so cool. Like, you can actually see the flights and the numbers and stuff. So I'm kind of like, I'm hoping we can name our ships and like coding and things like that. So we can actually have, could you imagine like the fun you can have if you name your ship?
It isn't always good for stealth gameplay because people can basically track you down and tell you where you're freaking going.
True, well, but then you can mask your ship, can't you? You have to mask it and say you're something else. It would be a real cool feature.
Why did track someone?
That will eventually make it in where you could, you know, like if you're at one landing pad and loading and you're looking for crew, or you're heading off to somewhere else and you're loading up, you can say the Nomad Caterpillar, my cat, is loading, needing a gunner if anyone's available. You'll look at this and you'll be like, right, platform J45, let's go out there and accept the job. So yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah, basically. I really like that. And then I think there was there another thing. So bug fixes, that was it. Reddit one. There's a huge list of bug fixes this person was talking about. We don't have to go into huge amounts of details on them, but it was just talking about bugs and stuff. So well worth having a read. I was just curious if anyone's got any off the top of their head now. If there any bug that you wish you could fix right now for 3.0, that if you could just magically do a wand right now, if there's a bug that you would say yes.
All of them. No.
It would be the missing doors, or it's either the missing doors and seats, or the quantum travel bug where it's like rubber banding. You jump and then you're like, yay, and then suddenly you're like straight back where you started.
You're the funds.
Hey. Yeah, one of those.
I think the one where I can't get off the landing pad.
Without jumping, I went over because I was trying to trade between landing pads. I went from B to
lazy
C,
bastard,
hovering over it, asking for like permission to land, and it just wouldn't keep giving me. And next thing, and I was back on position, landed on the pad on B again. I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you're like, whoa,
instant landing, blink, and you're there. I was like, that's the new technology they've got of auto land. You just appear on it.
Yeah.
What I hope they fix is the I don't know if it's really you can call it a bug. The terminal prices of goods at the moment are a bit all over the place. You know what I mean? There needs to be a bit more structure in it. It's what Miss says. You go to a different pad and there's different thingies. You know, so it's like.
I think they might have fixed it now, though. Is that everything was exactly the same price between?
Ah, okay. That would be great. You know, so you can get a bit of trading going. You know.
Is that what Miz says about jumping from strut to strut in Port Olisar? There's no way Port Olisar struts should have different pricing.
Prices, yeah.
They should be the same all around. Because someone on one strut will be like, mate, you realise you're charging like twice as much as... Well, they wouldn't be. They'd keep quiet, wouldn't they? They'd be like, hey, I tell you what, let's fucking undercut them by like 50%.
So, yeah. It could happen.
Well, it could, but then that needs to be... set at Olisar, I think that's
but
what
that defeats the fact a bit that
that's what I'm saying. I think they fixed that trade. When I went, they was all the same. So
what you got is people just jumping from pad to pad, you know. It's like, oh yeah, I've been trading today. I haven't left Port Olisar though.
Well, yeah, that's some people are saying that. I mean, I'm kind of torn between not liking it and kind of liking it, because obviously if you go to a mall, you can sometimes buy one item of goods in one shop at one price, and if you walk 5 minutes, that, yeah, oh, no, 2 minutes shops, in the shop. No, but that's
Port Olisar. But if you went to say like on a Banu merchant, or you went to say like a Levski where it's individual stalls, then that would be kind of cool to have that feature, because it'd be different traders in the more
different traders. Yeah, like
at Levski where you have the market.
You can buy like hanger posters. You can buy fish. You can buy all sorts of... Have you ever seen that at Levski? Have you even looked around the market?
Yeah, it's awesome.
There's so much little cool bits that you'd be like, oh, just get that Wingman's hanger poster, you know? Yeah. I like that addition. It's really cool.
But yeah, Miz, exactly. That was kind of exactly what I was trying to get at, was that in theory, Port Olisar, yes, if everything's the same, then there should be no price difference. But if they did have different shops at Port Olisar, then that would be a justification for why you could go to Strut A and sell the goods in Strut C. Maybe, you know, you could do that. But it wouldn't make much sense for the gameplay, but, you know, that would be my only justification.
Yeah, it would all depend on if Olisar have independent sellers. Or if they have a united, whatever.
Yeah, judging on what it is, the way it is, the clean and this, it would just make sense. It's all the same price, and that would just be fixed. And you know, maybe there would be a different price between one type of UEE, you know, station to another station. Do you know what I mean? Maybe that, like as if a Shell garage, you know, you have different Shell garages charging slightly different prices for their fuel. You know what I mean? You know, that would be the. If they're in a different location, and I think they did talk about that in the economy, depending on where the location is and stuff, prices will change. So
yeah, I am very surprised that 3.0 has the dynamic economy like it does, where if people are constantly selling buying and selling the same thing at the same place, it'll adjust the supply and demand. It's just all it comes down to. So you know, the buy low, sell high. If everyone's doing the same thing, the economy's not going to sustain that. And that's what I like about it, is that the fact they've got that in now. And that's what 3.1 is as well, is balancing things like the economy until... Because they're doing it in with small things before they introduce ships. Once ships are in, then it's kind of like a bigger asset that you would want to delve in buying and selling. So they need to do it with small things. Then they'll introduce other bigger things and ships. And like maybe even get clothing and weapons before the ships come in. We'll see.
It's, but I agree. First time I've done the cargo running this patch today was the first time I did it, and I really was impressed. I mean, apart from obviously losing, it crashed and I lost, you know, one of my deals. Literally, I think it was, we were on the same server and it crashed, and I had just bought, like filled up my cutlass or I just bought like 1,000 whatever it was of goods, and it literally crashed immediately after I bought it. So that was a bit of a pain in the ass, but generally it's a shame that they doesn't have persistence in that sense. Like I bought the goods and it doesn't hold the goods for me even though the game's crashed. I hope they fix it.
Like if you win the magic one bug fix, that would be it, because the crashing means like I've only got a certain, especially when you got a small amount of money, if that crashes, like I crashed and then my ship was stuck in Levski, but it even though I was at Levski, it respawned me back in Port Olisar. And it's like, well, if you at least try and respawn me in the same place, because then I can get my ship back.
Do you know the bug that I want fixing is when I crash my Caterpillar with $100,000 UEC worth of cargo, that it doesn't, I don't lose it all. I mean, what a shitty bug that is.
Yeah.
I flew into Levski with like 100,000 worth of cargo and crashed into the planet of the asteroid. All blew up. I lost everything. What a shit bug that is, you know?
Yeah.
But it could have a bit of element of tension to it, though, because like Madness is like, well, do I trade big or do I go balls deep and spend all my money?
I traded big. It was a bad choice.
Yeah, but this is it.
Isn't that part a bit of fun though? For now,
it does add a bit. Yeah, I mean, considering we don't have much else to do, really, that works quite well. It is that kind of. I'm kind of like I'm trading a little bit now at the beginning to get to a point where I can say, right, I've got this excess that I can potentially lose and not be shit, but it's a good chunk. Or do I just go, fuck it? I'll just go 95% and do a big, you know, Aquila run and pray to God that I don't get interdicted, or you know, it works out really well. And then you're thinking to yourself, I hope that no one's stream sniping me, because it's perfectly possible someone could be stream sniping me right now as well. So it's certainly adds to a bit of tension.
I went balls deep with my 100, my full 100 AUC cargo.
Big loss of that, I tell you.
Big loss.
It was complete incompetence.
It was so funny though. Miz was like, okay, so I'm just going to buy this. I mean, to be fair, I cocked up as well. I did actually have a face plant moment because I reclaimed my ship thinking that it would include the cargo.
Yep.
And then I flew all the way with my ship back to Port Olisar.
Everybody in chat let him carry on. He flew all the way back.
And then I was like, open the back, open the back. And then I was like, I didn't think about it. I just literally just wasn't thinking. I was just like, duh, 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 duh,
didn't put you think
on.
When you walked in,
it's empty.
Yeah.
You would have thought that would have been a clue, wouldn't you? But
well,
you know,
you're too hyped. You're like, this is going to be a good day.
Yeah, I know. I was like, it's servers running well.
Cargo
made it.
People
landed.
Probably said it, but he's never listening and he's never reading chat.
No,
so.
But,
yeah.
I was reading chat, but no, it was that was. You got to fail to learn, right? And I failed epic, so I learnt pretty quickly. So that was good.
Will
but yeah,
Smith
that
did a good snapshot on that today.
That bug
to
would
fail,
be good.
You have to fail again, and then you have to fail and beyond. Go beyond
failure. Yeah, for sure.
Well, we're really good at the fouling part.
Yeah, that was
it,
that was
very good at the fouling part.
I wish I could give Miz money. That was the thing that we're talking about, giving money. I was like, he's so broke, and or maybe we could share the
three units of aluminium. I said, can I just sit in Port Olisol with a hat out and go, oh, can I?
Yeah. A busking mechanic.
Just busking.
Somebody buy my free aluminium for more than the station's going to pay.
I don't know what you were doing there, Sol, but that didn't.
Sol,
like...
that look.
It was playing.
Sol was one hand. We can
What's
only
the
see
one
hand?
Sol. What's
there
the one hand?
We can only see one hand, mate.
That's fine. I do that in public. It gives me a.
You do that in public? Well, you're in the right place. You're in the asylum, so you can, you know, carry on. Just start throwing shit against the wall. It's fine. No problems. start painting, doing a masterpiece with your own feces. But that's true, though. Like we were saying about the busking thing. But in the ship, though, for me, like I would like to be able to, for example, Mac. We could split the cargo, so you could buy half the cargo. I could buy half the cargo of what we've got, and then we take the ship, and then we would do it together, and then we would trade what we've added to this one ship to sell, and then we both make a profit, and then that way we could both fly one ship. Okay, go for it.
You can just maybe an option where you can say, okay, I want to share this loot or this run with my party members.
Mm-hmm.
So you just have an option when you buy, say, profit for party leader, profit to share with party, something like that.
Yeah, they will have an app on the Moby Glass which will allow you to share the loot. You know, allow you to, like, if you're especially org management apps, because that's still to come. There's a lot of org management that's coming out of Turbulent and so forth.
Yeah,
being able to split, because obviously, if you are the owner of the ship, the captain of the ship should get more for the sake of expenses like fuel, maintenance, that sort of thing. So they need to get a bigger load than your average, like, mopper. So, yeah, it's going to get split between them. What the fuck are you laughing at?
Can we get some money for how many times he's going to touch that toilet roll?
I'm just unmop. Done. I'm out of beer. There's no more spillage, all right? Fuck. I had an accident.
The euphemisms of choking chickens and toilet paper around and all sorts. It's just unbelievable.
I froze a beer. It's a problem that we all have to face now.
Oh, I've done that. Do you know, I freeze. I hate it when I do that because then you kind of go, it's all the gas is gone, but you still kind of,
I've
still drink
it.
Well, I didn't used to, anyway.
I've done that in my mate's freezer once and got wasted afterwards and we found out the next morning.
Yeah.
Oh my God, the mess. Because they explode, basically.
But that's the thing. That's what happened. I brought the beer back. I didn't realize it was frozen.
You tapped it on the table.
And then foam everywhere. Yeah, no.
So I'm salvaging what I can. And so far, I've got half a glass of floating. I don't know if you can see it. There it is.
Put it in a microwave for a moment.
I'm not going to fucking microwave my beer. We've seen what happened to the potato.
The day of microwaving shit just to see what happens.
Yeah.
Madness. Well, this was the Asylum Podcast.
See ya.
See ya.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching, everybody. Did he expect us to carry on talking? Should we just sit here in silence and let him come back in
awkwardness? Subject before he just walked off. We can't just talk about Max choked chicken all the time.
Yes, we can.
Oh my God! I heard every single word of that. It was hilarious. Okay, so yeah, so the last, where is it? I got really cool pictures. This is the Levski monorail. And man,
the hat sticking out with the ball on it.
My next purchase is going to be a new monitor.
I love it. We've got a whole new show, but nothing changes, which is a good thing. We've got the Levski monorail. So I was like, I haven't really properly looked around Levski, but the idea of this, I really want this to work. I want to get in the Levski monorail. I want to go around Levski monorail. I want to sit in it and just get taxi.
$500 for Apple.
Yeah, it's so cool. Is he just advertising all the time?
He's just advertising.
Like $2,000 for Apple.
Shameless advertisement.
I might just start flickering.
He's trying to get partners.
This is just like constant product placement from him at the moment.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
Like, poor Matt is just trying to plow on.
I'm just trying my best, but it's just been sabotaged all the way through. I may as well just start. I should just join in, really, shouldn't I? I should get my Penn State pretzels. Start eating my Penn State pretzels.
I've got some of them. They're nice.
These are good. These are really good. Let's get back to advertisements.
It's hot in here.
How else are we supposed to make money on Twitch? There's no other way.
Monetization, exactly.
Exactly. There we go. This is how you do it, Mac.
Shameless.
Don't do it.
Oh, wow.
Shameless. Okay.
So, yeah, the Levski pictures. I haven't done a lot of exploring around any of that yet because I had a really shit Christmas. So I haven't played the game at all. So I was like, you know, I haven't looked at all that yet. So I'm looking forward to exploring some of that.
I think Mrs. Wife has gone to bed. I had a shit Christmas.
It's like, let's not ask. In case
I'm just covering Mac at the moment with the more appropriate video. It's all about the advertising.
Hey, right? Wayne.
I don't know what people do, man. It's like people only do things for money. Oh God.
Sorry, I will actually tell you when I'm earning money from a sponsorship, and I will milk the shit out of it.
Milk it, yeah. Milk the money. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. There's some really cool decals. Reddit is literally just people taking loads of cool pictures. But this is quite funny. I thought this was really cool because they had the drugs and then they had like the kind of the teddy bear and things. I love all these kind of like Easter eggy kind of clever bits that people put into the artists and stuff. Have a bit of fun. So I'm a big fan of all this stuff, and I hope people post lots of this as they come across it, you know, all these more and more of this stuff. It's great to see.
I probably still have a couple of bags of drugs. It doesn't look like that, I can tell you that.
You're looking at your ball sack right now.
No, I was going into my drawer.
Your drug drawer.
My drug drawer, yeah.
I'm trying to think if this. Oh, hang on, here we go. This is a video. This was something I found. I don't know if anyone else has seen this. Have you seen this? The let me see if I've got the right location. This guy found there's a shield bug. I don't know if this has been fixed. Now, anyone can correct me if this has been fixed. Hang on, I'm going to bring this back up. There's a shield bug in the cutlass. Now, I don't know if this is 100%, but if you watch the video, he shoots his gun. And then boom, look. The doors are open, and the shields, look, he's shooting through the ship. And the shields don't trigger.
That will be a bug if that's the case.
That's working as intended.
Well, here he goes. Let's try this.
Taser.
So he's not able to damage the cutlass in that location. I think he blows. I don't know if he blows it up, but
Is that a Grim Hex?
I think so. But anyway, I'll just go back. Yeah, it's going to take a lot. It does. The rail gun does take a lot, but it just shows you like firing, and then right there where it comes, there seems to be a hole in the shields.
Is he hitting
it's like a hole. I think he's hitting it. Hang on, we'll move on a bit.
That's Arena Commander, that is.
Yeah, that is.
Not that it matters, but it's Arena.
Arena Commander.
There's a lot. This is probably part of the 3.1 patch that comes in with a lot of balancing. They've got the new shield tech as well that's coming in. I think it was supposed to be in the demo that we saw for Squadron 42, but it won't work properly, where every ship will have a more dynamic shield to the shape of their ship. GPU rendered, is it? I don't know if that's right. No one can help. Fucking great.
What do you mean? So what do you mean? Sorry.
As in, it's instead of it being CPU generated, it's the particle effects for the GPU. Sorry.
Oh, the GPU. Oh, the fact that
GPU particles. Yeah. So I think it's the GPU that's rendering now the shields, which save a lot of memory. They save a lot of technical computer stuff that I don't really know about. But it's most likely that 3.1 will bring a lot of fixing to things like the ship's damage, the shielding, and so forth. Anyone fucking mention anything about the shields?
Sorry, no? I was muted. I was muted for a second. Shit, I was going to say. They have. I know that they're doing the GPU stuff as well to do with Spectrum, and they were going to do the VoIP stuff. Is going to be using GPU as well, right? From what I understand, wasn't it? It's going to be doing. So it doesn't surprise me that they're going to start to split systems and try and save obviously CPU memory, because you just can't keep going up and up and up, because our CPUs will literally melt. You will have to have the latest huge CPU in order to play this game in Alpha.
Like,
they have to
about that big.
How much do you think that they will eventually, once they optimize, will switch over to graphics, to be graphics reliant, do you think? Will it be 50-50, do you think, or will go more to GPU and less CPU?
It will depend on how, if the GPUs are increasing in performance, then there's no reason why they can't utilize that. It's all dependent on what is released from the companies that produce that particular component. If like the GPUs now have the ability to have high memory, so that's why they're utilizing it. I believe my fucking monitor's flicking on and off. I want to take a picture, but I feel like I'm being.
Make a picture. Just hide the logo. Hide the logo. Yeah, there you go.
Strike
you
a pose.
You know exactly where it is, though.
I'm gonna wait for it to happen because I can see it.
Just gonna sit there while he takes a picture.
Wrong one.
It's not fucking working. It flickers on and off, and then it comes back.
So how would you want to make a picture of a flicker? Isn't it better to make a video?
Quick button.
A flicker. You're about the website.
But a flickering.
Flicker.
Wait, that's true. I can't be asked anymore. Fuck you all. It's gone.
Stop it. Right, let's move.
Oh, we can do questions. Do we have questions? Did we even open questions? I didn't even know.
We got three questions.
Wait, anyone else? Oh, by the way, if anyone wants to, brackets, questions, and we will, you know.
Brackets.
Let's do questions. I think the last thing I was going to say was wrecking gear, weapons not working, but we'll save that for another next week. And then
wrecking,
something else.
Breaking news, weapons not working.
Wrecks not working.
We can use one of our wrecked ships in thingy now, though, right? In
you can use the ships, but the weapons, for some reason, seem to be not working very well. So
a wreck, REC stuff.
REC stuff, yeah.
REC
stuff. And this was it. I'm going to show you.
Previously, REC ships, pre-patch, you cannot use NPU, though, I've noticed, because I still had ships available for a certain amount of days that I could not use in PU, and I already had a Cutlass Black on REC. I had to wreck a new Cutlass Black in REC to get it into the PU. So everything that you had on REC, because I still had, what was the guns that we always used on the Sabres, Madness?
Yeah.
How are they called again?
What, the Panthers?
No, the good ones that we always had.
Oh, the Tarantulas.
The Tarantulas. I still have tons of them in my REC. I cannot use them.
Yeah, that's the same. I'm the same. I've got loads of stuff I can't use. I'm guessing they're going to eventually delete or get rid of this system, so I'm guessing they will wait until they figure something out. This is something from CIG, as me CIG, so I'm hoping this is an official person. I mean, most people that put CIG.
Yeah, AMZ
could be Doc. AMZ is. Okay, cool.
As me,
correspondent.
Okay, good. So I just wanted to make sure. So this, let me just zoom out a little bit so I can read the whole thing. So it says here, I don't know what's in response to, but somebody just clipped this on Reddit, and it says, if something that you own is destroyed, say a Constellation that only has 3 months of insurance and it has run out before it was destroyed, you'll need to pay more to have it replaced in game, but it won't be permanently removed from your account. Okay, so hang on, let me, because I'm dying again. Hang on, so carry on.
items like shields, weapons.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Still working on how insurance will cover these items that are included with the base ship, but it won't be a case of them being gone for good. So what it basically means is stuff you're paying real money for will never just vanish because you've lost it and you haven't got it insured, which makes sense. I think that has been a question on a lot of people's lips for a long time.
Do for legal reasons because you purchased that with real money. So there is a legal aspect in that as well.
Yeah, you can never lose it completely.
And it would make sense. I mean, you'd piss people off massively if you thought you'd put money in the ship and just because you forgot to get it insured.
We need to do the Heimlich on Malice.
Oh, I've got something stuck. It's been stuck. It's something tickling the back of my throat.
It's that dildo again, isn't it? You should get that out.
I swear to God, honestly, I've been practicing the whole circular breathing and kind of trying to reduce the gag reflex. It's just not working.
No.
It's really struggling. You can give me some tips
later.
I'll
give you a good technique. Yeah, I'll let you know how I do it. Yeah.
He'll show you a Brinson going out and
I'm going to quit this podcast.
Nothing has changed, has it? Everything is still the same.
It's all exactly the same. It's just a complete, it's just a pretend.
It's a different kind of asylum now.
Yeah, it is. We can get away with it more.
The asylum is all normal now, basically.
Let's do questions.
Go. Question time.
Question time, people. And then
we need the BBC Question Time music on when you do that. Question time.
Let's do it. That's on my list of things to do. So we will get. Let me write it down.
A jingle.
We'll do a question time jingle
for you. You need to do a lame ass jingle like what we.
We'll
just
do a lame one. Yeah, yeah. All right. Lame
not
jingle.
A quality one that Sol can do.
No. Lame.
I have to be honest. I recently got back into my music production again, so I could make you a crazy thing for an intro. I'm working on a techno track actually.
Techno.
Okay.
Minecraft.
Not exactly the same time then.
Minecraft.
Wow. Great minds think alike. I love the fact that we're...
Questions.
Let's do first question. Let's roll in with it. Let's see if we get any more questions.
First question is from Gundam, and he says to Mr. Sol.create, podcast when you never play Star Citizen? Sol always plays Hellion.
Can I say something? Mr. Gundam Citizen, you are probably a great person.
No.
Fuck you.
And I know you don't like me, but that's fine. You know, we're all different. You know what I mean? And I probably play this game more than you know. I'm just not waving around with it on Twitch all day as I used to do. But it's fine to sometimes, you know, be a bit jealous at a person or something like that. It's all natural that what people have. So if you want to come and chill with me, I invite you to my Discord and we can have a chat about it. And we can have a drink together and kiss about it. Let's talk about it. You know, it's all fine. But
what I like is that
I played more than enough stars.
Okay, let's move on. Go past Sol whilst he's talking nonsense. Let's get to question time.
What I like is that you were complaining about the smoke in your face, Sol, and then you vape. I just saw this actual real smoke, so I was thinking. Is that smoke in his face? Hang on a minute.
Next question is from the prisoner, and he says, can you explain object container tech? Many seem confused at what that means.
Yeah, 42.
Oh, God. We explained it earlier, didn't we? Didn't we explain it really earlier?
We covered it. If you missed it, then the podcast will be back up on YouTube. You'll be able to watch it on there. And we explain it crystal clear. On a section of the podcast, just watch back.
This is where you come to get facts. This is it. This is all facts here, baby. Nothing but facts.
So the next question is from Training Wheels, and he says, are you skeptical of all the listed mechanics making it into 3.2 all at once? How would you prioritize them?
No, I'm not skeptical because it's tier zero. So it's the very basics of the mechanics, which I think mining especially, they already have a pretty much basic mechanic of that working. Salvaging I think they said they're going to introduce the paw, the personal arc welder, as a way of using welding, cutting, and for the time being, the sort of tether tool. So I don't think it's that big a struggle for them to get a basic version of it. It's not a case of getting a massive completed version. It's just the very basics of it, which I don't think it'll take that long. It won't be what we expect, and it won't be anything like the final version, but it's going to be enough.
I mean, some of those features we were supposed to be getting in like 3.0 and stuff, like the mining, they were hoping to get it in 3.0. They said they were a little way off of it, then it's obviously been pushed back because they want to change that more. So although there's a lot of features in the June patch, you're talking about another 6 months down the line, which means it's stuff that they could potentially have got in 3.1, but they want to polish a bit more. This is stuff that may well have almost been ready to push now, but they want to make sure it's in a better performance before they do it. So by putting it back, in some ways they've already put it back by saying it's in June rather than implementing it in the 3.1 patch.
It's overdue.
So,
ready. Been ready for years.
Yeah, it's been done, ready. It's just sitting there taunting us with it. That's all. So yeah, I think there's not a huge, I mean, from that schedule report that we've all just read out earlier, there's not a huge amount promised. So there's quite a few mechanics on that one. I grant you on that, but I do think some of that is stuff that's, we know was almost or should have almost been done. So I think it's definitely doable.
I'll be interested to see about repair and refueling. I would hope they would use the Starfarer for refueling, but repair, I'm not sure what they're going to have in terms of, but I assume it's not going to be a ship like the Crucible. We're not going to see the Crucible for that. We're going to see more of the personal arc welder of welding and fixing things. It could even be a case of, let's have a laser that just, you know, handheld laser that just automatically repairs things as a basic tier zero, just to get the functionality of things being repaired rather than how you actually go about doing it. Yeah,
a bit like a cross key that you have in your car, so you can take a tire off and put it back on again and drive home on your spare tire.
It's not generally the process of doing it, it's the getting it done by hand.
But like, so say the mining result. If you had it on a very basic thing, you could have the prospector go up to a rock, shoot it, and then it fills the tanks in the back of different materials. Yeah. You're not really seeing much.
We don't know what tier zero means.
Basic thing, yeah.
Wait and see, I guess. I mean, I'm skeptical. The question was how skeptical, right? I'm notoriously skeptical. And in terms of prioritizing, personally, you know, my priority is obviously combat. So I'd like them to improve combat as much as possible because it's PvP. That keeps people entertained as well, adds a bit of tension. Improve the entertainment of that. I actually want farming in, but that'll come in hopefully with the land. So they've got to do the land bit first. So I'll just have to wait for that. What's the thing? The economy. Passing the economy and the priority for me is getting ships. Their reason to spend money in game and to grind a reason to grind for ships.
You can still find a lot of PvP though if you go to the hotspots more, you know, if you hang around Levski.
It's just an EMP fest, isn't it, really? That's the problem. It's not really fun. It's not fun. It's not combat. It's just people just flying around in ravens and just EMPing each other.
There's not a necessary reward because persistence is working, then there's more of a reward for pirates to be more active, for people to be more cautious, because otherwise what's the point? It's just fucking about. There's not actual benefit to owning anything, and I think that'll come mainly beta later on, you know, when the patches last longer and the persistence is in.
Although this is nothing to do with the question, I think on that in terms as well is that people 3.0 is very new, so a lot of people are wanting to test the mechanics that are available, which is the cargo trading. And this happened in 2.6 and everything else. People did all the missions, first of all, and they wanted to do the missions. And then they moaned because people were attacking them while they were doing the missions. And I think you're getting that a lot at the moment. People, you know, there's so many bugs and so many crashes, and it's costing people a fortune to load up the cargo and then get destroyed. These people want to do their cargo runs. When this has been out for a few months and everybody's done all their cargo runs and made a ton of money, you may see a swing back to combat because people are like, well, we've done the cargo bit now. Let's do some missions. Let's do some combat.
As long as the combat works a bit better, but they need to improve a few things in the combat mechanics for sure. But I agree. I hear what you're saying. I just think The other thing is at the moment, in terms of piracy and stuff, you know, it would be great for them to improve the ability to, you know, I could steal your stuff and sell it. Do you know what I mean? I could take your ship and fly it to Grim Hex and sell it.
Well, you don't know with these little interim type of patches these sort of things will see improved. Like combat and that, they might be little patches that are not mentioned in that.
That would be a priority for me.
Fixes that are constantly coming through. So
that would be a priority. I think for me to be first, one of the first kind of combat things would be to be able to sell stolen goods. You know, that would be
fight adventures. I'm surprised with the economy in at the moment. I'm surprised they haven't introduced defense for those who steal. So I suppose boarding and breaching would be the next. They would need that in first before they have a fence.
Because we can't steal the pick the boxes up because the boxes are too big. Yeah. You know, so there's
physically... what's the point in having a fence if you can't actually sell anything on? You know,
so you can only steal the person's ship.
Which
you can't sell the ship.
They
or
will
the
probably
goods,
come very it? Similar times, and it will be the very basics of that gameplay until they have it more fleshed, and then they'll just like everything they'll get the tier zero, which will be very basic, and then build.
I'd like that. Mm. That would be a priority for me, that would add a lot more fun and tension, and you know, you would a bit more untrusting of people, and you know, because a lot of people are going to get trusting of people because people are not really going to steal stuff now because you can't sell
it. Next question. Edison Trent, do you think we will get more ships as will we get more ships as just the whole sea in 3.1, since most of the 3.1 ships are already in game, like the Prospector and the 85X?
I would like to see I think the Razor, the Reclaimer, and the Hull Sea are practically ready. But it's whether or not they'll introduce them without the mechanics, which I wonder
if we're going to get them dropped when they're ready, rather than being held for a big patch or anything like that.
They will drop them. Like, I'm hoping that the big patches, they have covered what they're going to put, the main focus of each patch. They've got the focus. So things like clothing, weapons, ships, armor, should hopefully be just a byproduct of whatever's ready at the time.
Yeah.
And hopefully, if the Reclaimer, the Hull Sea, the Razor's ready, they'll just introduce that when it's done. Like when it's ready, and then they'll, like the Prospector, they'll introduce the mechanics later. Because the sooner they get a ship into the game, the sooner we can be testing it and finding the bugs and quashing the bugs, so that when the mechanic works, we're not being sucked out of the ship. We're not being fucking, you know, glitching out of the hull or whatever. You know, get it in game as soon as possible so that we can test it first.
Yep.
Okay.
Nailed it.
And the Terrapin, sorry. Yeah, well, yeah.
True. Terrapin. Ooh, I would love the Terrapin.
Something to do with the Terrapin, like scanning. They were this close to getting scanning mechanic in for the demo of Squadron 42. And it's not just like what the intention they had when you know, when you went over to the Odin 1's moon to speak to Trio, who was in the location. You know, they had the clusters of shit from satellites that have been destroyed. You remember you on the demo, you were supposed to go over, speak to Trejo, the advocacy agent. You're supposed to scan that area and find her and track her down. You're also supposed to scan and realize that the pirates were masking their IDs as someone who has been dead long since. And also, when you go planet side, you're supposed to scan to find a good entrance into the Salava base, but scanning wasn't working, so they removed all that.
Well, how did they know to go there? And
That was supposed to be ready. So the Terrapin may have more of a mechanic when it comes out than anything else.
It would help the Herald as well, because the Herald, you know, is...
Well, yeah, any ship that has, like the Aquila, any ship that has a scanning suite should have more of ability, and that should be out pretty soon, I expect.
This is what we're saying. I think we're all genuinely probably quite excited for 2018, because we know with the Delta Patcher and with the language and the fact that I think we're all in agreement that 3.0 is a fantastic base to build upon as a game now.
Definitely.
So, you know, very excited for this year and next year. Very excited.
Yeah, super hype.
Next question.
Next question.
Carlos R72 says, does any of you use the power presets in anything other than normal balance preset while flying?
No.
I will be, yes. I've been speaking to some of my combat friends, and we've been chatting about some stuff. So I am going to be doing a pirate session and learning. So I will get back to you once I've learned some more about the stealth and power settings.
Yeah, it's going to be stupid.
And I had voice attack to control it. I can't go through all the menus and keep changing it during combat and stuff, but when I had voice attack, I used to say, like, power to the back of the shields or whatever when you was getting hit. But I haven't set voice attack up for a long time.
Yeah, I've been waiting to really see the game, and like I said, I've steered clear of combat, but there will be a lot of, I've been chatting to a few people, and they've been telling me like tricks and things that they've been learning and doing and stuff. I mean, I'm not going to share certain things because obviously some of the things are private for tactics, but overall I will do a rundown of things that I'm allowed to share and stuff.
Like about. What is private?
Well, there'll be things that people have spent a lot of time learning, and they're like tricks and things that they've learned in terms of their tactics for combat or like for EMP, like avoiding missiles and EMPing stuff.
Well, how do you do that? How do you avoid missiles?
That'll be for another day.
Listen, though, there was a time that there was something that a way you could avoid torpedoes, basically. And Madness did not want to share that for a long damn time. He was like, no, I'm not telling you.
Like a crazy person.
The thing is a lot of people, they tell me things in confidence, and I kind of like, I'm like, well, I won't, you know, they sell me stuff and I won't share it, and then there's other things they say, well, that's okay, you can share that. Or once information starts to spill out to people, then, and people start to figure it out and stuff, they're like, oh, you're doing this, I can see from the stream you've done this, you've done that, you know. Then they tell me, they say, is that what you did? And I go, yeah, that's what I did, you know. That's fine. But generally on the whole, if I'm learning something, I won't necessarily share it, especially for a combat situation, because it gives people an advantage, and then eventually, you know, you have to go learn. So that's the way.
No, I agree. When it comes to like org training and things, you will show, like if I do videos, I'll show little snippets, but I won't show the full org training session, because then you'll know our tactics and you'll know we do things. Yeah,
it's just part of the, you know, we have to. Yeah, exactly. You know, it's too easy just to teach you. I mean, I remember, I don't mind teaching people things. I've never had a problem, but if I'm asked to not share it, I won't share it. It's that simple. Well, yeah, you have to be.
The pump
is loyalty. You gotta be. He's sharing Nike or some sort of like, you know, Quicksilver on the back, like logo in the screen.
What brand is that hat, Mac? Where did you get it? What was the price?
It was a Christmas present.
Oh, okay.
O'Neill, I think. Not from O'Neill. I don't know an O'Neill, but it's O'Neill.
O'Neill, okay.
Just in case anyone wanted to, from O'Neill, wanted to sponsor question
who?
My stream.
O'Neill?
Did Neil give you this, yeah?
Yeah, that's another 200 quid just then.
Oh,
right,
Neil, yeah.
God, unbelievable.
Anyway, next question from Mr. Dirk says, do you think that the object container streaming being planned for September update should be swapped with the optimization update planned for March? Why optimize in March when you have to do all the work over again after OCS is in?
They are still putting patches out. Putting patches out now. We are getting updates and patches and things. So
it's different. It's a different optimization. The optimization that's coming in March is to make sure that, like you said, with the graphics on the shields, we're making sure that things run smoother, that textures load properly, and that sort of thing. Whereas the object container is about making sure that not everything gets ready when you're not there. They're different technologies.
They have certain techniques that they know will make a big difference, which they are working on because it's new tech. But they also have the classic tech that every game goes through when they optimize stuff. That is going to be a constant thing throughout development. But this big tech stuff should, fingers crossed, make a big difference when it's eventually ready. But the normal stuff is just stuff they'll constantly do all the time. From now till we all die.
Forever.
Yeah. Forever. I need to be.
Yeah, well, there he goes again. £500 for the expenses.
Just bring it really close. Just give it a kiss.
What series is that? It's the drifting series.
God.
You can drift with that thing.
The question is, what is your hardware that you guys play on, Xbox or PlayStation, because it looks way good for PC? Yeah. Next question.
Which hardware are we talking about?
I think this man, if he can tell me his dealer for what he's smoking, then let him know. My Discord, I posted it earlier.
I don't use Xbox, but I do have a PlayStation 4, and I do have an Xbox controller. I'm a console person myself, so and a PC person as well. So
I play whatever games. I just game, so I don't care. I'm a gamer. So yeah.
Okay. So the next question again is from Dirk, and he says, "No mention of purchasing ships in game with UEC on the schedule report. Should we still expect it from 3.1? Well, we kind of covered that. We hope that it'll still be in for 3.1, but at the moment it's not listed, so they're not being held to it, I suppose.
Yeah, they're keeping themselves. They're keeping that one. Yeah, they're keeping that to themselves. But I really do. Yeah. Yeah, we spoke about it. Next question.
And the next question is from probably the same troll that asked the last one. When will this game come to Xbox One? Since the Xbox One can easily run this if you pay $2,000 for a PC, so can the Xbox One.
Right. I mean, it's an interesting thing if whether Star Citizen would ever go onto console. The reality is that I can't see it happening because the requirements will be, you know, they constantly seems to be requiring too much power from what I can tell. I mean, the CPU at the moment is like.
So, oh, you never know, consoles might get good in a couple of years' time and catch up, but
could do. But then Star Citizen, I imagine, will be constantly,
possibly.
Constantly. You know, I think the only chance that's
never say never
is Squadron 42 as a like a consolidated version.
Is it me or is the phone coming out even more at the moment? Maybe. On the right side?
Phone back in.
That phone back in. Poke it all back in there, not Princess Leia.
I'm gonna have to look at all this. I'm gonna have to watch this video back because I can't see on my tiny little crappy little VGA monitor exactly what these other guys are looking at.
You don't want to see it. It's not important.
Any more questions, Miss, or is that
one more?
One more, and then we'll wrap it up.
Shambles. Do we have any idea when we will be able to transfer cargo from ship to ship in game? So this is what we were just talking about, sadly, we don't know when.
Hopefully, I would like that to be one of the priorities. Honestly, I think if they're going to make cargo running a strong feature, I would really like them to really, in a way, like continue to build on what they've already got. It's fine adding other things as well, but I really want them to polish a bit more the cargo.
I mean, we can stuff. Trade the wreck stuff, can't we? So if you go to like where the wrecks are and pick them boxes up, you can kind of give those to other people. But
selling them doesn't
literally
work.
Literally, stuff
well.
You've bought, you can't. Can you not sell those?
Well, you're supposed to be able to if you click on the NPC and you place it on that square. But I've tried like three times and it hasn't worked. We will get a breakdown this month, which will cover hopefully more in depth, like specifically what is coming with each patch. So hopefully that.
Didn't they say?
They did say at the end of that update.
On the 3.1 enhancing performance, polishing game systems and gameplay, including ships, blah, blah, blah. A large balance pass of our economy, improving AI. So I think with all that, the balance on the economy, that's all going to be part of like trading, I would have thought.
Definitely.
Yeah, I think, and they do recognize that obviously there's a great amount of feedback that we've given them over Christmas and beyond, and we'll continue to give them, you know, all the time. So they'll have that information to sift through and to take and glean what's important. So I expect, I'm hoping that to come sooner rather than later this year. It'd be good to have like cargo and economy and all the rest of it nailed this year. Do you know what I mean? It would be like if you could have anything kind of like nailed, like perfect, that and then a good amount of the combat nailed, and then tier one salvage and stuff, that would be quite cool. Like what and then get that nailed next year type of thing, and mining nailed next year or whatever. Mm. You know, just get them really good. Really good repetitive gameplay that we can enjoy. That's and then enable us to buy ships and
can't tell
be a good year.
Sarcastic.
Repetitive gameplay.
Is it competitive or repetitive?
Repetitive and competitive. Both. Repetitive and competitive. Would be fun.
And that's it for questions.
That's it. Okay. Good stuff. So to quick roundup and then what you guys are up to this week. I will start off with the guests of the show. So we'll start with Sol.
More streaming of the beautiful creative things. Probably some more streaming with drones. We'll play some Hellion, etc. You know, people cool. can stop by and see what I do on a daily basis. Some other people can stop by and can see what success is like, you know. And for the rest of it, we're just gonna have a lot of joy, you know. Just enjoy life and enjoy the beautiful community that we're in. That's
cool.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Good stuff. Mac, this week, what are you up to?
That's a weird noise. Catching up with... I don't know where that came from. Catching up with everything that I've been missing out on because I've been ill.
Do you know what you need to do? Before you talk, Mike, I was going to say, you need to do I'd love to hear your unedited version of your YouTube videos, like a bloopers reel or something, you know? That would be hilarious.
I have once, during a there was one part of a video that I can't remember what video it was now, but I was literally, like, stumbling on the same word for about 6 seconds. And it was, by 6 seconds doesn't sound like a long time, but when you're recording a video and you're trying, and you're speaking as fast as I do, 6 seconds is a lifetime. And I was like, fuck, I'm putting that at the end. Because it took me such a long time to record and edit and so forth because I was fucking about and I just couldn't get it together. But yeah, I might do like... the problem is, at the moment with memory problems, I delete everything as I go because I just can't afford to save it.
If you record it in Audacity, you delete, chop and...
Yeah, you edit your Audacity file.
You get rid of it there at the time. That's what I'm doing. So you kind of don't keep it, but yeah.
That's it. And it was that one section that made me chuckle to myself that I thought, fuck it, I'll put it in.
You could do like a segment called six seconds sex secrets, you know what I mean? And just
6 seconds sex secrets.
Yeah.
Wow.
Something like that.
It'll take him 6 seconds to say 6 seconds sex secrets.
1, 2, 3, done.
Ah.
That's all it takes. But yeah, it would be a good idea to do some sort of like outtake thing. Oh. If when I get a bit more memory, I'll save bits of audio and so forth that I find funny, and I'll keep it aside. But other than that, I'm trying to get some videos sorted. Trying to get more in. That sounded like someone fapping. I think it was a keyboard stroke though. I'm going to try and get more of a schedule on YouTube, because at the moment it's kind of just as and when I can get information and when I get on, when I'm not working and so forth. But I expect early this year to become full-time this. That is my goal. Before the six-month... Yeah, soon. That could be fucking any time. That's the intention.
When they fucking give you partner, the bastards.
When partner comes, that'll be a lot better, because then I can start working on sponsorships and... Like, I mean, I could contact DX Racer and say, I literally pissed like 6 times in four hours. So you're going to get more exposure than most streamers get. But yeah, that's the intention is to go full time. So lots of streaming. We've got the Banner Merchant giveaway. We've got the February giveaways, which is $200 worth of gift cards, 4 starter packages, 552 Merlins.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
Connie, 2 300Is, 2 315Ps, 2 Cutlasses, 2 Constellation Tauruses, Freelancer, Hornet, fucking loads of stuff, courtesy of Raiden, as well as the sub goals. So there's a lot of giveaways going on, which I cannot thank the community enough for that. But other than that, I'm just going to be getting on to normal, as always.
As always. Yeah. Nice. Good stuff. Miz?
Yes, I don't know. I need to get back to streaming a little bit more. So obviously Mondays will carry on being the Asylum podcasts, so we're back on track with those, I think, hopefully.
Yeah.
And then on Fridays at 8:30 PM, I think, UK time, we do the we're on the fourth episode now of D&D, so a group of us are getting together and doing D&D sessions. There's about seven or eight of us. We're all kind of learning as we go, but it's been good fun so far. Madness is one of the team. I'm the DM. I'm learning how to DM. I've never done it before, so it's kind of it really is a learning as we go session, jumping in at the deep end. But it's been really good fun so far, and I think it's taken off quite well. So look forward to more of that. And then obviously
the show's called Stout and Sturdy, by the way.
It's called Stout and Sturdy. It's all going to be under the Asylum banner, so we will be sticking, hopefully I'm going to edit those, because Twitch lost the first 3 episodes, which is really annoying. So we're going to download the fourth one and I'll try and do some editing for it, and we'll upload it to the Asylum podcast, the Asylum YouTube,
yeah,
and things like that as well. And then, yeah, Tuesday night is Paint, Prattle and Roll, which is where I paint miniature figures, or at the moment we're currently working on the space, we're a spaceman for Star Citizen. So I think
Space Marine.
There we go, that one. I'm currently working on painting that, but that's not the one I'm actually painting. But that's Tuesday late night, something like half.
Isn't there an idea for Mac to send that to you and that you paint that for him?
I'm only doing one for Dez, but yeah,
meticulous.
That's gonna be Miz's new thing, is painting everybody's
stars. Yeah. You found a hole in the market there, we would say, man.
We paint and we talk about gaming, and we'll probably talk a little bit more about this Asylum thing and some of the things we've got planned. But yeah, like I said, we're aiming to do some other games as well as Star Citizen. So we're going to look at probably doing some videos, and maybe, we don't know if we'll stream it, but maybe another like little podcast type review thing or something on some games as well. So quite a lot coming forward in the year. That's just not next week. I've gone for
That's like a long time. This is definitely a week. Yes, all next, all happening in 1 week's time. That is very much long-term goals for the Asylum. So we really want to grow. We're going to try and do lots more content. We really want to try and expand on what we've been doing and learning and stuff. So you guys can have, come and enjoy, and we can try and bring creative people on board that want to do stuff. And perhaps we'll need to, want to kind of like fall underneath the banner of the Asylum. And, if you want to do something, you've got an idea, feel free to pitch it to myself or to me.
I've got an idea. Make a banner, an Asylum banner, because everyone seems to fall under the Asylum banner, and without an actual banner.
Or should we have it lower so that people fall over it rather than under?
I like the idea of the people falling over it. Yeah, that sounds good.
What was tripping that? It's the Asylum banner.
It's the Asylum banner. That would be great. So we've got lots of plans, and
under my pay grade.
We'll try and do some good stuff this year, and then we'll see where we're at. But it's always about, it's for me, it's in life, it's about, there's what you say you want to do, then it's kind of like lip service, and then there's what you do. And so for me, it's always like, let's try and find the bit where we're actually going to do what we say. So we're realistic, me and Miz, we both have full-time jobs, we've got families, we've got stuff like that. So we do need other people obviously to come on who've got other ideas, and maybe people, for example, if you've got your own channel that's dedicated to one particular game, but you recognize that maybe you want to try and use something else and put your work onto something else YouTube wise obviously you still advertise on yourself, but then there's an opportunity there if you want to talk about other games. It won't disrupt your current channel, but you can use the Asylum as a place where you can put your put some videos and content and stuff. So yeah, that's pretty cool, isn't it? That's pretty awesome.
That's fucking awesome.
It's a very funky blue there. I like it.
Blue.
Shit's all over the boring. I'm a soldier. Those little soldier figures.
What is your one doing? Is your one falling off a landing pad or something like that? Hold it up again.
Mine? What do you mean? It's exactly the same.
Hold it like that. Yeah, he's falling off a landing pad. It looks.
Put it on the side.
Actually, what is yours doing?
Oh yeah, why is he leaning backwards?
You've melted him.
It's the casual one.
Fucking drunk. That's the problem.
He's been shot. That's the one that's been shot. If I could put you up on my you can miss a shot yours.
He's fine. He's okay. All right.
He's already dead.
In a minute. It's gonna
be interesting stuff, guys. Interesting stuff.
We got lots of plans anyway. So, but we're just gonna roll through a few things first, and let's get the YouTube channel up and running.
Sounds good.
And
step by step.
Yeah, I'm going to be doing that. I'll be working on Asylum stuff and work and D&D on Friday. So I'm looking forward to it. Always love my D&D sessions now.
I want to, can I take the opportunity for a moment and being a bit sentimental again? I just want to, and I posted it on Twitter as well, and I forgot to put Madness in the post, which was the worst thing I could have done.
It's okay, I understand.
I want to thank everyone that's in here on the podcast, and also a lot of the viewers for supporting me in my choices to become a designer, which has worked out really well. And I want to take the opportunity to personally thank Miz, Madness, and also Ryan for supporting me through it and helping me out, and Without them, follow the dream. Without them, without them and other people that I already mentioned in my Twitter post, I wouldn't have come so far. So thank you very much, guys. For
a pleasure. You know, just work really hard. Keep doing, man. Just keep doing what you love.
Work hard, craft hard. You know.
Yeah.
No, don't work hard. Work smart. Don't work hard.
And as we're talking about thanking people, I just want, again, just a big shout out to all the people that came and enjoyed the last year of the whole year, supported us through the Addicted podcast. It means a lot to me. I know. I hope you stay and enjoy and continue to enjoy the show, of course. But, you know, thank you. And hopefully this will be a new kind of future for all of us in this world. So, yeah. Good stuff.
New year, new things.
New stuff. It's always about trying new stuff.
I've stepped out of the Addicted podcast a while back, but I still want to encourage the Addicted guys to do what they want to do and keep on doing things as well. You know?
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. We'll always be. You know, it's always going to be a part of what we did in Star Citizen, so that's never going to change. And I'm affiliated to the Addicted org, and that will be. It will stay that way. Until, you know, whenever.
Until they kick him out.
Until they kick me out, yeah. For robbing them blind. All right, should I host somebody? Who should we host?
You can post links, Des.
Crucian?
He was here today. Crucian doesn't need the host. Does he need the host?
I say the few.
The few.
Should we look who's got very little on staff?
The few has 4 viewers, but he's a great, great streamer. I would suggest doing the few.
Where is he? I don't even see him.
I'll give you. It's like THE the few, as in not a lot.
Oh, the few. Okay, yeah. I saw him the other day. I've never posted him before. This is Asylum, so this will be the first one from the Asylum. So go give him a host, Chuck. Does anyone? Do we have a little raid logo or something?
Yeah, exclamation /raid, and then it sends everyone there.
And make sure you come and watch our D&D sessions. Good fun.
Yes, come and watch us if you like D&D.
Watch
definitely on Friday.
Do it.
Miz's channel, so just make sure you follow Miz and on Twitter and Twitch and all the
follow
rest of it.
Follow us all. Follow these guys.
Follow all of us. Right, okay, forward, raid. By the way, and if you want to patron us at some point in the future, if you enjoy all the content that we're delivering, let us deliver the content first, and if you like it, we definitely going to need some support from you guys. So it's raid, and then it's the few, right?
F-E-W. And also all spelt out T-H-E. Which doesn't help. We all know that means the.
But her? I cannot pronounce that. The.
I'm is that very... correct? That's correct, isn't it?
Yes.
This is where I find out I'm raiding some random
guy. Give this guy a follow. A newer streamer in the Star Citizen community.
He's gone for a piss.
Has he?
Yeah. Probably.
It's all right. He'll get back.
Okay. I can cancel it.
No, don't cancel it. Just go.
Just
thanks,
all right,
guys.
We're going.
Don't forget, next Monday, come and join the Asylum podcast. Goodbye.
That's it. They're gone.
That's typical. Everyone will be there ready. Don't worry.
He's going to go, what the fuck just happened?
I just saw him literally get up and go for a piss. I was like, ooh, get in there, man.
He needs to get one of them DX racing chairs.
Advertising that chair again. Good start to the new year then, guys.
Yeah, man. That was awesome.
Thank you both for coming on.
Mm.
No worries.
Anytime.
Enjoyed it.
Unless I can't, then not anytime. But yeah, anytime.
But just not anytime.
What's he saying? I can't hear him, but never mind. Doesn't matter.
I don't know. Is he back?
Oh, he is. Probably has no idea what's going on.
Yeah, he's.
He doesn't know. He has no idea.
Yeah, probably not. But anyway, whatever. Enjoy.
Good. It went quite well, guys. I was quite happy with the way that the transition, like the.
Oh, that was cool, man. You did really well. That was cool.
It did look really cool.
People were like, what the fuck is happening?
Yeah. What the fuck is happening?
I was like, yes, that's good, man.
That's good. That's what you want. And then they're like, oh, eerie. And then, yeah, that was and then the bouncing music. That video that the guy did, Star Citizen, Frost, the Frost Master, is amazing.
Mm.
He's so bouncy. It's got such a great beat, such a perfect tune.
The thing
as well.
Is, I watched some of his other ones and I didn't.
No.
The video he's done is good. But I don't like the music. I think getting the sound right, and the one he showed off that's done really well, he's hit the nail on the head with the sound. The other ones, yeah. I didn't like the music so much, and I kind of stopped watching them after a couple of seconds. Well, not a couple of seconds. I think they're about 2 minutes. Other ones are longer, and I was like, no, it's too much of like.
Yeah.
Whereas this one he's just done is perfect. Yeah.
It's absolutely perfect. Yeah.
It was a really good transition. It worked really well.
Yeah, it did.
We might have to clip that bit, and then we can. Tweet it out as a change thing, maybe.
We had a rate of 42.
Yeah.
That's good.
Nice.
Round
like all proper raids.
Awesome. That was really, really cool. Thank you so much.
And by the way, for both of you guys actually in chat, I'm dead serious, by the way. We are going to be doing this YouTube channel. We are going to want to do stuff if you're free, and if you want to do, if there's any games, anything else that you don't do outside of what you're doing that's interesting, could be movie related. If you want to lend your voice to something or you want to lend your expertise to anything, we will need it. We want to do it. We'll definitely.
Anytime you need anything, give me a shout. If I'm around, I'll help. Voice, games, anything. I love you all. So whatever you need, just let me
know.
Man.
Yeah, I'm free. And like I say, if you've got something you're interested in wanting to do, Mac, and you maybe don't have a platform for it, or you want to, maybe it'll interrupt with your current YouTube channel or whatever, feel free, man. You can chuck it on the Asylum. It's fine, dude. And you can link through. Man. It's absolutely cool. Because I know it might be quite tricky because you're very much Star Citizen based, right? Your channel.
True. I mean, I do intend on bringing a bit more to YouTube because I'm still quite small. So I intend to shape it a bit more in terms of other games like Escape from Tarkov. And other things like that, and product reviews, because at the end of the day, I want to get people to send me products, I want to get people to send me games, and the only way to do that is to start doing that.
But Mac,
yeah,
don't let that stop you from asking, because I'm going to be honest with all of you here in the channel. I ask for codes for every game, and for 70% of the games that I ask, I get codes. I got a code for World Adrift. I got 5 copies of Hellion. I got 10 copies of Gold Rush, the game, And obviously, the bigger games, it's a bit harder. Escape from Tarkov said, oh, you're too small. But, if you don't ask, you don't get, who cares?
No, I do ask.
At the end of the day. I have a couple of other games. I have keys to give away, Hellion came to me and said, oh, do you want to do some giveaways here? You got a couple of keys. If you play the game and you're interested and you follow them on Twitter and they retweet me, it's you are at a size where it should even be easier than it would be for someone like me that has only 700 followers.
It's a good sign, isn't it, when they